from the CBS studios in Dallas, Texas, it's the Russ Martin Show, starring Russ Martin, with J.D. Ryan, Eddie Boyd, Trey Trenholm, back, Dan O'Malley, Gail Lightfoot, and the Russ Martin Band. And now, here's Russ.
Very nice.
We should have that installed, actually.
What? A curtain, curtains to walk through?
Yeah, walk through.
We have curtains up against the wall.
Yeah. I know. I looked like an idiot when I walked behind him and then came out.
Oh. I closed my eyes. I didn't see you walk behind him.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you. All right. What are you doing in here?
By the way, quite a lovely Jethro shirt you're sporting today.
Thank you.
From the Max Baer line?
No.
Okay.
Polo. I was going to give you a James Brown. Found out why he didn't call yesterday and what happened.
Okay, what?
His flight didn't get in until 6:30. He was flying by private jet. His manager was flying commercial.
Uh-huh.
And the manager said he'd get... I guess he has a personal valet that travels with him.
Who does?
James Brown.
That's what they call it. We know what he is.
What was that?
His handler.
He had given the valet the number.
Yes.
Evidently, the valet didn't realize he could still call when he got in at 6:30.
Oh.
They were very apologetic. The manager's in town, and they're going to call at 5 today.
I don't want him now.
Okay.
We're busy.
Mm-hmm.
Big day.
Busy day. You don't just... Do you just not show up to the Tonight Show and expect Jay Leno to be happy about it?
Well, he couldn't help that his flight was delayed.
And all phones everywhere stopped.
Well, it was a mistake.
Yeah, okay. Well.
We don't have time for him today.
Okay.
Busy, busy day.
Huge.
More stuff than we can imagine.
Oh, yeah.
It'd be fun to hear him.
Hmm. Content packed show. Don't you hear it? He's in town then, right?
He is in town.
At his hotel.
At his hotel.
If they want us to promote where he's playing this weekend,
okay.
They got to get his ass in the studio. They bumped us yesterday. I'm pissed off. They want him on, and they want us to promote it. They get his butt here in the studio. We'll send a limo for him. Bottle of whiskey and some guns. If he wants, we'll have some troopers chase him here to the building.
I'll see what I can do.
That's not see what you can do. Tell him that. If they want him on the show, they get his ass up here. They didn't show up yesterday, and they didn't call.
Unfortunately, the venue...
Yes.
Where he was playing, wiped the hands of booking him or dealing with him a long time ago.
So? What's that got to do with me?
It doesn't have anything to do
with me. Well, you say the problem is?
If they were in control, we might have better luck.
Okay.
So I'll go relay your message.
Thank you. Let me know what they say.
Okay.
That ain't no polo shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Only thing he's missing is a rope belt.
JB collection.
Yeah. Polo. It's a Jethro. Yes, Brian.
Hey, how are you doing?
Good.
Good. Hey, I have heard you talking for a couple weeks about this bar that you want to open your power tool room and all that good stuff.
My what room?
Your power tool room.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it sounds awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to call and offer my services to you. I have a company. We do consulting for basically people just like you opening restaurants, bars, nightclubs.
Mm-hmm.
We can help you with budgeting, menus, hiring, interviewing, training, manuals, whole nine yards. Wanted to offer my services free of charge if y'all need any help.
Do we need that help ever? Yeah, that'd be great. Yes, we'd love to have your help.
Fantastic. We'd love to help you.
What's the name of the company?
B&B Private Consultations.
And you do all that stuff.
Absolutely. Basically, what we do is turnkey solutions. If you had a wad of money and you came to me and said, I need to have a sports bar by TCU,
right,
we would handle all the details. Of course, you're going to need an attorney like Everett to handle your licensing and all those issues.
Can you do all that?
Sure.
Okay.
But anything from, I mean, even going so far as making materials to train managers, training your staff, things like that.
And you'll do this for free?
Absolutely.
It's a good price.
What's that?
I like it.
Hey, that was a good one.
Thank you. Let me put you on hold, and Dan, you already have it? All right, we'll be calling you then, Brian.
Okay, thank you very much, Russ.
We going to see the bar this weekend?
Yes.
All right, when do you want to go?
Saturday.
Saturday morning?
Morning or afternoon, you pick.
I like morning. Want to get it out of the way.
Let's do it. Come over to my house about 10.
Of course, because the bar is near your house.
Well, yeah, it wouldn't make any sense for me to go to your house.
Isn't it funny, of all the places in North Texas, Everett picks a bar close to his house.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be close to your new digs once the station moves.
We don't know. The station may not move for 2 years.
Well, nevertheless, this bar is going to go on
well,
forever.
Well, nevertheless, the station may not move for 2 years, so it's not going to be close to me.
Truly, it had nothing to do with where I live.
Truly, yes, it did.
No,
yes,
it's a good location.
Truly, yes.
It's a good location. Actually, it wasn't even my idea. It was suggested to me by someone in the industry.
Hmm. So I forget, if this bar is doing well as it is, why do they want to sell it?
I'm not sure exactly why they're selling it. I know one of the bars that we looked at is being sold because of a divorce.
Oh, that's always good.
Mm-hmm. So you know the various reasons why people sell bars other than profitability. Plus, bear in mind, we have an added incentive for people to come out to the bar. You.
But I got to be there.
Well, not all the time.
How big is this place? I asked you that. I'm trying, in my mind, I'm trying to think of the different stuff we could do with it.
3,000 square feet, roughly.
Okay.
A little bit more.
That's enough to set aside like an 800 square foot room instead of a smoking room, the one with the power tools.
Yeah, absolutely.
I love that. Just get a lot of dollar gadgets to where it's not really expensive stuff. Just, you know, things like, hey, I need that twist tie. Not twist ties, slip tie. What do you call those?
Plastic things.
Yeah.
Tie stuff up with you.
Yeah. I bought like 8,000 of those. I went to that Harbor Freight in Garland.
Mm-hmm.
It was like $7. All different colors. I don't need those ties.
No.
But they were there and they looked cool. And I knew sooner or later I'd need one. And I did.
One?
Yes.
How many do you have?
8,000.
All right.
Slip ties, I think is what they're called.
Yeah.
Whatever.
You can use them as handcuffs in a pinch.
Did somebody just grunt dog vomit in their pants?
Not I.
Edward?
No.
Because it smells like dog grunt.
No, I'm proud of mine. I always tell you when I do it.
Mm-hmm. Nobody smell it. It was like a quick woofed.
Mm-hmm. Sorry.
And I don't mean dog. I'm the puppy grunt. That's mm-hmm. what it smelled like. Who passed a puppy grunt? Nobody smells that?
Nope.
Damn. All right, so anyway, I want to have the room and put all that stuff, put it on the walls. Inexpensive stuff.
I think it's a great idea.
Yes, John?
Yes, Russ. Why don't you also have a room for women so they can have some items to purchase? And that would also draw a good crowd for the ladies.
We don't have room for that, do we?
Probably not.
I'm thinking of the whole Home Depot idea of that, but with whiskey. God, that makes me hard just thinking about it. Every time you say that, just a Home Depot, if they had, I would even settle for beer. They just have that when you go in.
Power tools and alcohol.
Why is it they don't do that?
I don't know.
You can make it a private club, can't you?
I don't see why not.
Well, like JD said, they do it out of Grapevine Mills at a boot store.
Yeah, and they give it away. As long as you don't sell it, I think you're good to go.
Right.
Why is it nobody's all over that?
I mean,
especially if like a 24-hour Home Depot.
They should try it one time.
Yeah, a marketing
watch
profit.
Watch profits just soar.
Not just because more people would want to go there. Mm-hmm. More people would buy stuff because they're drunk. All right, so when are we going to go?
Saturday morning.
All right. 10 o'clock?
Sure.
Perfect. All right. Yes, JB?
Jethro. Mm-hmm. JB said, his people said it was just impossible.
Well, then I say tough noogies.
Okay.
To the James. Too bad. We could have packed that place.
They said he will actually be in his car on the way to rehearsal.
He could be there all he wants. I hope he enjoys the ride.
Okay.
Don't bump me and go, hey, we'll just come on today.
I mean, honestly, they have rehearsal.
So?
Well, he can't skip rehearsal for an interview.
He's been doing the same, excuse me a second, goddamn songs for 30 years.
I know.
He don't need to rehearse. I can do his act in I can get ready for his act in 3 seconds.
Okay.
Watch.
Okay.
Yeah, that was good. Thanks.
Yeah.
Rehearsal. If he goes on at 8 o'clock, you know damn well he's still in a car at 8:15.
Possibly.
Thank them and then tell them to be gone.
Okay.
We won't be enjoying the James Brown today.
Okay.
I'm disappointed.
Why?
I think that would have been fun. Talk to a legend like that, even though he's hard to understand.
Should have been more professional.
Well, it's not his fault the plane was late. He's not flying the thing.
He's got time today.
Sure.
I want to know what his problem is, why he can't come into a studio. Either somebody did something to him, or he wigs out and starts slinging stuff. Either way, it's fine.
Right. Both are entertaining.
I pray to God he'd come into the studio and wig out. I wonder if that's a wig. It's got to be a wig.
I think so.
And I'm almost positive he's got false choppers.
Yeah, didn't you see?
I think I've seen him without them before, yeah. Where he gets the old woman face, mm-hmm. Where the chin goes up near the nose. Mm-hmm. You about ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Jeffrey?
Rosiah,
yes.
Got a great idea for the bar.
Mm-hmm.
Fix it up like the Batcave, so when you come to the bar in Batmobile, you whip in the little door, and the car is in the bar in a sectioned-off little area so everybody can check it out. What do you think?
I'm looking at Everett. We're making eye contact.
It wouldn't have to be a big area, just the area, you know, for the car to come inside, and it could have, like, maybe a little wall around it, not close enough so they couldn't touch it. You don't want them touching it.
No.
But where they could see it, man, you would be Batman if you had that set up, brother.
Kind of like they do the horses at the racetrack. It could actually be a separate area where they can't get near it. They can just see it through the glass when you pull in. Door goes up, you pull in, door goes down. Private area for the car.
Exactly. It would be so
nobody
cool.
Nobody can get near it.
I think the expense involved in the build-out would...
Why? Just a room.
Yeah, but you're talking about having a wall knocked in, essentially, to have a garage door open and close and then park it and take up room in
the
bar.
We'll take one of the hammers out of our Home Depot room.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Oh, I hadn't thought of that.
Yeah, they just beat the wall out. Thanks.
Those roll-up doors can't be that expensive.
And you're talking about finish out? How much extra money do you think that we would make if we had the car on display?
Well, I don't know.
I would weigh that out then.
Okay.
And plus, since I'm thinking about getting a second one, we could have one on display.
Oh, yeah. If you're going to have one on display, absolutely.
Finally, a place to use that stupid bat stone I got you.
Oh, yeah. We could put that in the bar.
Yeah.
300-pound bat stone.
It's only 3,000 square feet.
What, the place?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. Sorry, no room for the bat stone.
We'll leave it here.
How affordable is this place? Because I'm starting to think we need a little more room.
It's affordable.
Well, it's just not convenient.
Yeah. Like square footage. Do you know?
How many square feet does it
have? No. What is per square foot cost?
Well, I think the rent is around three.
$3,000?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Is that average? $1 per square foot?
I haven't done the math, but I mean, in terms of...
About 3,000 feet, $3,000.
Yeah. Roughly.
Okay. I'll dwell on it. But the guy's right. Having a car there would be cool.
Yeah, if we could facilitate it with a minimal expense. We can certainly look into it.
I'm sure somebody probably be open to helping us out.
You think?
Yeah. All right. Well, here's James Brown's bio that we don't need. He would sweat up to 7 pounds off during one night.
In
a performance. Mm-hmm. Being sued by his daughters for back royalties. Oh, I read this yesterday, didn't I? My favorite part is he shot up his bedroom. The only black man that knows how to riot. You shoot up your own stuff. You set your own stuff on fire. Right. You flip your own car over. Shot up his bedroom, pulled a shotgun on an insurance. See, he wrote on here, pulled a shotgun on an insurance seminar. What the hell does that mean?
No idea.
Sounds like it should be salesman, but...
That's probably what it... Because someone used his bathroom in his trailer.
Could have been like at a hotel, who knows.
He led then police on a high-speed chase through two states. Police had to shoot his tires out to get him to stop. 1980, threw his wife's fur coats in the yard and shot him down.
That's funny. Are you sure you don't want to have him on?
I think we probably heard the best stuff.
I guess.
Then she later burned all his clothes.
And he's worried about missing a rehearsal?
What does that mean?
Well, here's a guy who'll take the police on a two-state car chase,
yeah,
and yet he's concerned about missing a rehearsal for an act that he's been doing for 30 years.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Exactly.
He doesn't have to rehearse. He knows it.
Probably more like sound check, to be honest.
Here comes Pink Nipples. Maybe something's changed.
Mm.
Is he coming in? Did you already cancel?
Yes.
I think I want him now. Hurry up. We got to do news. All right, fine. Thank you. What?
After allegedly shooting up the walls of his bedroom, Brown pulled out a shotgun at an insurance seminar in Augusta, Georgia.
Well, that's not what you wrote on here. You said on an insurance seminar. Made it sound like he pulled a gun out on everybody.
He did.
You said at.
Oh.
This says on.
Oh, sorry.
You ever stop and wonder who the stupidest person on the show is? I thought about that in the shower today. Not the least educated, because I think if we had to break it down,
mm-hmm,
it wouldn't be too far off between, Eddie and Everett. And Trey would probably be a close second, because he's educated. He's just stupid.
I made a typo. I'm not stupid.
Yeah, you are.
No.
Yes, you are. I just said you were educated. Why can't you take a compliment? Didn't I?
You did.
Why I did. What?
Some people just put a negative spin on everything.
Yeah. I'd be curious to see who the most educated person would be.
Educated as far as degree or educated as far
just
as...
Just as far as their knowledge. Knowledge of stuff.
Well, we know it would be between...
Everett and Eddie.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah.
I think Trey would probably fall in there someplace not too far behind. Mm-hmm. Seems educated on stuff.
He's just stupid.
Mm-hmm. And it just makes you wonder how he got that well educated, but being so stupid... How'd that happen?
I made a typo.
I'm not talking about just this. I'm not going to base my whole evaluation of you based on this. It's a complete look at you and your life and the way you function.
Okay. How is that?
You're stupid.
No, I'm not.
Okay, you win.
See?
You beat me down. Obviously, I was wrong.
Stupid.
Do we have the sixth grader questions?
Yes, I believe we do somewhere.
Where are they? We don't even right now. I'm going to do news. Here's what we'll do. We'll do news, and we'll come back and find out who the stupidest person on the show is.
I don't want to play.
Well, you and me don't have to play.
Oh,
because I already know we're out.
Okay.
We have to moderate. Moderators certainly don't. You ever see Alex Trebek answering any of the questions?
Never.
And you know if they weren't written down, he wouldn't know the answers.
Mm-mm.
Well, Everett and Eddie are smarter than I am.
I gave you credit for coming in close behind. And I'm not talking about smarter. I'm talking about educated.
Okay.
Well, you seem to be well-educated.
Okay. There's a slam coming somewhere, so.
Yeah, I know. You're stupid. All right, let's do news.
Okay.
See if you can find the...
I know exactly where they are.
Okay. Fetch them for me, please. Here are the keys to my office. There you go.
You want James Brown?
Yes, I'd like James Brown now. I'm sure he'll be a delightful guest.
Yes.
All right, 3:32, J.D. Ryan's on the New York.
Live one of
And your Us News brought to us by Expedia.com and by Dodge. Final of the weekend, Friday, March 28th, 2003. Vince Vaughn of Swingers Superstar. He's 33 today. Reba McEntire turns 48. Ken Howard is 59 today. Brady Seals used to be with, he's basically the cousin of Dan Seals, but he used to be with Little Texas. He's 34. Lucy Lawless, 35. MC Hammer over the weekend will turn 41.
Dan Seals of Seals and Craw?
It is Brady Seals, and he's his cousin of Dan Seals.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
Brady's a younger kid. Celine Dion is 35. Donna DeRico, 35 also. Paul Reiser, Mad About You, 46. Eric Clapton, 58. Sunday, Warren Beatty turned 66. John Astin, who was Gomez, 73. Peter Marshall is 73. And Frankie Lane, who sang the theme too.
Rawhide, very good.
90. Somebody should get him. Well, he's only worth 10 points. U.S. government officials are now fairly certain Saddam Hussein is alive and in control of his military. They think he's constantly on the move through a series of underground catacombs that lead from one bunker to the next in and around Baghdad. Incidentally, defense officials confirmed last night that the first 5,000-pound bunker buster bomb was dropped on an unspecified target during a Baghdad bombing run yesterday. Iraqi troops currently taking up positions around Baghdad. They're even digging trenches downtown. Their goal is to force the coalition forces to come into the city to fight. The defense minister said, quote, the enemy must come inside Baghdad and that will be its grave. The Pentagon says there's almost 90,000 troops in Iraq, an additional 100 to 120 on the way by the end of next month, about 225,000 American troops there.
We decide we want the bar. How long before we can open it?
Well, it depends on what we need to do, how much build out we need to do, what location we pick, things of that nature. We'll know more after Saturday. If we're good with this location, then, you know, depending on whether or not you want to entertain the possibility of doing the build-out for the car.
Yes. I think that's a good idea. Because I could swap. On days that I can't have the Batmobile there, the Mach 5 could be there.
Okay.
But I don't want to finish the club out as a Batcave.
Right.
That's getting a little too
out there.
Yes. Go ahead.
Muslim and Arab groups say they have reports of backlash crimes are starting to trickle in, and they fear an increase in, and if the war increases, rather, so will their attacks. Advocates who track such incidents say they've heard about a dozen potential hate crimes, most involving verbal harassment or property damage to Arabs and Muslims since the war began last week. NASCAR is in town. Racing fans gathering in North Fort Worth for the big weekend at the track. Qualifying rounds are taking place today for the NASCAR Samsung Radio Shack 500 for Sunday, the seventh NASCAR Winston Cup race to be held on the half-mile quad oval track. The Speedway is expecting more than 300,000 people to attend NASCAR race. So if you're thinking about going out westbound 114 or north on 35W, don't bother. It's going to be a mess. Security extra tight this year at the Texas Motor Speedway, where guards are inspecting every recreational vehicle that comes through the gates for anything suspicious.
Don't do this.
Hello, Walt.
Thank you.
The car of Winston Cup champion Tony Stewart.
Hey, what was the story about Eddie Gossage just pissed off about at somebody?
There's a group of people that have put up a tent.
Excuse me.
Adjacent to the Texas Motor Speedway.
Yes.
It's 25,000 foot, and inside they were going to do
25,000
square feet. My bad. 25,000 square feet. Huge. Big tent.
Isn't that what you just said?
25,000 square feet. That's what it is. I thought I said, okay, I bet. When you corrected me, I thought I said something wrong.
I correct anything. 25,000 square feet is big.
It's huge. And it's adjacent to the Texas Motor Speedway. They're going to do a thing called NASCAR Girls Gone Nuts.
Okay.
A la Girls Gone Wild.
They're going to shoot, like, sex and whores in there?
They're going to get crazy inside.
Yeah.
And Eddie doesn't want it done.
Why?
He stopped them. He's suing them. Yeah, they even had a helicopter land on the property. They found out who the helicopter belonged to and called and bullied them. Said, if you ever wanted to do any business with that, you won't fly anybody into that arena. They're trying to shut them down.
What's his problem?
Because it's Girls Gone Wild and there'll be bad things going on in there. They have a liquor license.
Do they?
Yeah.
I want to go.
They said that.
I can understand why Eddie wouldn't want him out there, but I want to go. I want to go to NASCAR.
Uden.
Let's go.
It's not on the property. It's on private property adjacent to
that. I know, but that would bring business out there. The ancillary business?
Yep. That's what they said. They said also all the ads that they put out that had the words adjacent to Texas Motor Speedway,
right,
they had to cancel. They get the lawyers saying you can't say that. Well, it is a Texas adjacent.
Can't you? Ever, can you not say things like that, like next to Whataburger?
There's probably some sort of trademark infringement at issue.
But as you're using something as a landmark?
Yeah, but I think if it's a registered trademark, that's probably what's at issue here. In other words, Texas Motor Speedway, if it's a registered federal trademark, you can't use the name without their permission.
Oh. Hmm. So are they going to do it or not?
It'll be there. It's already set up. But it's just a matter of they all their advertising, all this thing. They can't advertise now because all the stuff says adjacent to Texas Motor Speedway.
Well, who cares? People already know it's there.
I guess. I don't know where the ads were running. Or
all you got to do is just put signs on the side of the tent. Girl's gone wild.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody will be at the car race.
Yeah.
That's probably what Eddie's concern is.
We'll have 800,000 people inside that tent.
People will be over at the tent instead of at the Speedway. And I've been to the infield, by the way, late at night on a Saturday night. It's not exactly church service.
What happens there?
People get naked and they're running around and drinking and it's insane. It's a party. After the race is Saturday, mm-hmm. Saturday night, that's the big night. Weather-wise, it may not hold out for them, but it's crazy. Everybody has campers, tents, everything else. Yeah, they stay there all night.
I want to go now.
It's an all-night party.
I love NASCAR.
Again, this is adjacent to. So wherever that 25,000 foot white tent is, that's where this thing is.
Let's go.
Yeah. When does it start?
It starts tonight.
Bye. All right, 347, J.D. Ryan is here. Eddie Boyd. What are you doing back in here?
Thought you wanted to do the Brain Quest deal.
I said after news. Oh. You thought what?
Thought we did news.
No, we didn't finish it.
Oh, nice. Sorry.
Just eliminated himself. You blow somebody during the break?
No.
You got crap on your chin.
Shut up. It's from the delicious food that we have.
It's still on your chin.
It's not.
Yes, it is. It's right there in that gap.
It's hung in his dimple.
Yeah, it's hung in your dimple.
The ranch dressing.
Yeah, that's what they say it is. From the ranch dressing hole.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Good today from the Big Apple Cafe in Arlington.
Good.
Delicious.
All right, go ahead. Where'd you leave off?
All right, speaking of NASCAR, the car of Winston Cup champion Tony Stewart was impounded today. It didn't meet specifications. It's a punishment never before handed out by NASCAR. Stewart, known as the bad boy of the sport, was forced to use his backup car at the opening practice. NASCAR has never impounded the entire car of a Winston Cup driver. Stewart's team could face other penalties or fines, but losing the primary car was damaging enough.
Thank you.
All right. Speaking of girls and websites, girlspooping.com has been shut down by the feds. As of yesterday, the website was still up. Michael Sharon Corbett of Lewisburg, West Virginia.
Wait a minute. Let's see if I can pull it up. Is it already down?
I don't know. This shit was up yesterday. The feds have arrested him.
Hold on before you say it again.
Here, the G and the P are capitalized.
I'm sure that's just to be able to read it. Girls. Oh, damn it. Did I spell it right? Girls. Oh, stuck a W on the end. Hold on a second. Did I spell it wrong? I left a W out. Hang on, I got too excited. Japanese hidden girls pooping download. College girls. That. What? What's wrong with people?
Chill up.
College girls, three. Email us, join here. Click your option below to sign up and get your user pass to download. Like I'm going to give somebody my credit card to watch people grunt. And what if they start running up bills on my credit card? What am I going to do? How'd they get your number?
Oh, it's a website.
I'm sorry, it's a website where what? Your Honor, could you ask you to speak it up?
Grunt.
A lot of people do.
We are using ProBilling as our processor, so you know your information is safe. Join here. There's no preview. ProBilling. College Girls 3. College Girls 15. Poop. What's the rest of the story?
Michael and Sharon Corbett of Lewisburg, West Virginia, were arrested for sending very obscene material to the U.S. mail. Girlspooping.com specializes in the most vile videos you can imagine, with titles like Outdoor Pooping Paradise and Tattooed Biker Chicks Pooping. The report also mentioned a bowl cam and, quote, violent defecation and whatever foul and putrid act you can imagine being done. The stinky is right there on video. The feds say they were shipping up to 30 titles a day, making as much as almost $300,000 a year. Girls pooping.
Why would you want to see that?
.com. People have weird fetishes. Who knows?
There are people that are into sex with amputees. I mean, there are all sorts of weird stuff out there.
There's nothing that I could think of that would be inviting about the other thing.
Mm-mm. I'm with you.
I just, when I'm looking at a chick, I just don't look at her and go, man, I wonder if I can get her to cup a squat on me.
You've said that before.
I'm not really let somebody cup a squat. What's the matter with you? I once in my life if I let a chick cup a squat.
For $30, you can get Britney squats. It's a 90-minute video. It's among the last Britney videos that will ever be released. It was compiled from the various custom
videos. Yeah, I heard that she tried to keep that from being released.
Mm-hmm.
Can't imagine why.
Huh? Over transparent bowls. It's a very intimate video.
Stop. Please. Okay. That's even yakking me.
Also loud farting noises in a few scenes.
Okay. I don't know. It might. I've never been so.
No.
Not even as a loop. Not,
no.
Now, monkeys pooping.
I
wonder if that's a website.
Hold on a second. If it's not now, it will be in a minute.
monkeyspooping.com. Looks like it's available. Chris, register that. monkeyspooping.com.
Thank you.
Chris will do it. Go ahead.
All right. Somebody sent an email explaining what's going on inside the tent out there at Texas Motor Speedway.
Oh, well, hang on. Let me read that then. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Speedway tent. Russ, this tent is next to to my campsite. The thing is huge. They're going to have a bra and panty boxing and girls oil wrestling. It's going to be badass. I also have two tickets for the Saturday race. If you want to see the Bush race, email me back if you're interested for the two tickets and all the beer you can drink. They also have told me that the tent has a $20 cover, but I figure it should be worth it. What's the one right below that? Is it two?
I don't know.
No. Oh, it's another link. Girls pooping. I must have spelled it wrong. Oh, that's... No. They're not even hot.
Yeah, but they're pooping.
Excuse me, would you like to buy a membership to this website? What is it? It's hot women. All the hot women you can look at.
Are they pooping?
No.
I don't want it then.
How much is the website?
$20.
And not one of them's pooping?
Mm-mm.
I don't want it. Go ahead.
Okay, and then somebody else has sent the website to the girls' NASCAR thing. Actor Martin Sheen covered his mouth with a piece of duct tape that said peace, then led about 60 protesters in a prayer vigil Wednesday. Sheen, the star of NBC's Right Wing, carried a huge painted cross during the protest. The vigil was held to pray for safe return of U.S. soldiers and to express solidarity with two Catholic priests and one peace activist who had been fasting on liquid diets since March the 5th.
Yeah, this is the website.
Hang on.
Let me pull up the properties. It is racetrackgirls.com. Texas size tent party, 32603. Click here. Oh, I wonder if it's got a live webcam.
Oh, that'd be brilliant.
Yeah, it's got video coming out. Tent party. Girls go nuts. Texas race week. Girls lube wrestling. Live. Bra and panties boxing. Wet t-shirt. I'm going to go. Okay. Can we go?
I'm sure we can get you tickets.
I want to get on the party.
You're probably already in the lobby.
All right, go ahead.
All right. Head of State opens in theaters today in the film When a Presidential Candidate Dies. This will be cut number one, by the way. Unexpectedly in the... Oh, did I not give you the...
No.
I'm sorry.
Thank you.
My bad. I'll read it slower. Anyway, it's Head of State is with Chris Rock, and when a presidential candidate dies unexpectedly in the middle of a campaign, the Democratic Party picks an unlikely candidate. It is Chris Rock. Here he was asked if fatherhood has changed his approach.
No, I don't see myself, I don't see myself becoming Cosby. No. I see myself becoming Eminem. He's got a kid. Hasn't tamed him down one bit.
There we go. Now, cut number two is a scene from Head of State in which Chris Rock's character is asked to run for president.
Mays, we'd like you to do something for us.
Yeah, sure. I'd love to work on a presidential campaign. You know, I'd make phone calls, set up flyers. Now, who have you guys chosen to run against Lewis?
Well, that's exactly what we wanted to talk to you about.
We'd like you to run for president.
Of what?
In the United States.
Of what?
Of America.
Which America?
North America. Please.
Get out of here.
Here we go. That's it. Big weekend, Head of State. Basic opens in theaters today. Also, it's John Travolta of the DEA and former Army Ranger. He's brought in by an old friend to investigate the disappearances of several Army Ranger cadets and a legendary drill instructor. Here, cut number three, John Travolta was asked if it's a bad time for films like Basic to show some military character as a villain.
The brilliant thing is that the military is a self-correcting organization and always has been. And that's the beauty of it, is that very few organizations are self-correcting. So I was kind of proud of the fact that, wow, this is pretty cool. This group of guys can go in and handle everything, plus get the bad seeds out of there.
There we go. Cut number four is a scene from Basic in which an Army investigator confronts a DEA agent, John Travolta, about his past.
Permission to speak freely, sir?
Osborne, I swear to God, you call me sir one more time, I'm going to scream.
I know who you are. The DEA is investigating you for bribery.
Suspicion of bribery. It's all in the wording, really.
The wording aside, I'm not comfortable having you involved with this case.
Well, three things. First, you don't have a choice. Second, I've never taken a bribe in my life. And third, I'm still a little drunk from earlier today. So if I skip over the witty banter and move straight into coming on to you, I hope you don't take offense.
Here we are. It's called Basic in theaters. And finally, The Core opens up in theaters also today. In the film, basically, the planet's magnetic field is rapidly deteriorating. Our atmosphere literally starts to come apart. And basically, the world's most gifted scientists travel to the Earth's core in a subterranean craft piloted by Terranauts. Cut number five.
I don't want to hear any more movie clips.
Okay.
It's like sitting at the movies.
I'm sorry. That's The Core. That's the big
one. Is that the one with Hillary Swank?
Yeah. And she was asked if there were any... Actually, the only reason this is interesting is because there's a scene with the space shuttle re-enters the atmosphere.
Yes.
And she was asked if there were any changes made in the scene which features the space shuttle returning to Earth.
Oh, is this her talking?
Yes.
All right.
Number five is.
All right. That was another movie clip.
Out of respect for the families, the trailer was cut a little bit differently, so none of the shuttle was in the trailer. And that was just out of respect to not remind anyone of anything like that. But it wasn't cut out of the movie, and the movie wasn't postponed or anything because, and it's a big question, because it doesn't mirror what happened at all. The only similar thing is that it's a spaceship, and I'm an astronaut.
And finally, cut number six, it's Hillary Swank on how some audiences have been reacting to scenes featuring the space shuttle in the core.
A lot of people are actually saying that during the test screenings, people are applauding when it lands because it doesn't crash and people don't die. That's a nice thing to hear.
There we go. Thought you'd enjoy that one. It's the core. It's in theaters today and throughout the weekend. All right, there's news and information brought to us by the Sci-Fi Channel of all people. I'm J.D. Ryan on Live 105.3, The Talk That Rocks Texas.
Where's Gail? Is she off? Who's doing traffic then?
His name's Craig St. James.
Sports guy from Channel 11? Number four? What?
That's Craig James.
Oh. Hey, Craig.
Hey, how you doing, Russ?
You get fired from Channel 4?
Yeah, you know, I just wasn't happy there.
Different guy? Okay. All right. You ready for traffic?
I'm ready. You ready?
Yep. What do you got?
Got a lot of thick traffic out there in Dallas. We're going to start off on westbound Northwest Highway. Got a bad accident just before Inwood Road. It's got the two right lanes blocked, so expect heavy delays through that area. Also on westbound 635, got an accident pushed off to the right shoulder at Marsh Lane, but still got a lot of onlooker slowdowns from at least Midway. Two problems in Fort Worth, one on eastbound I-30, the East Freeway. Right at Oakland, got an accident. It looks like just the left shoulder getting by, so that's a big-time slowdown for you. Delays from before Riverside. And if you're southbound on 35W coming out of downtown, just past Felix Street, we've got an accident. It's actually on the service road, but a lot of flashing lights have cars hitting their brakes and got you slow from Seminary. Other than that, looking pretty good. Traffic brought to you by Blockbuster Video and American Airlines. Blockbuster gives you a smarter way to buy DVDs. Rent Made in Manhattan. If you like it, you can buy a previously viewed DVD for just $9.99. Rent it, like it, buy it. Details at participating stores. I'm Craig St. James with traffic on Live 105.3, the Talk to Rocks, Texas.
Thank you, Craig. All right, going to be chilly over the weekend. 37 for the low tonight, then mid-50s tomorrow and partly cloudy. Nice day for race day Sunday, sunny and 62. We're 51 degrees currently. Live 105.3, the Talk That Rocks, Texas.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Did you cancel James Brown?
No, you said you wanted him.
No, he didn't.
You cancel him?
No.
Why not?
Because you might change your mind.
Told you he's learning.
Mm-hmm. Who you keep blowing during the breaks?
Quit it! Hello, buddy. It's ranch dressing for my salad.
Tossing.
Mm-mm.
All right. What's that number? What?
I can't hold. I can't read that. Your hands are shaking.
It's right here.
Oh, did you get her phone number?
Yes.
I'll call her some other time.
Call her?
I don't want to. I'm scared.
What are you scared of?
This was a chick I don't know that I really ever got over.
All the better reason.
What do you have to lose?
Well, like I said, it's a bit. If it goes south, it's a bit. You laugh, you hang up. You're in control.
How long ago was it when y'all dated?
Oh. What are we now? 2003. Oh, I just about finished my screw list. I got a bunch of holes in it. Either I'm a big liar, I didn't sleep with as much, many women as I thought.
You probably just don't remember. I was laying in bed this morning, came up with another one. I went, it's not on the list.
Oh, I just thought of one right now.
See?
An ex high school classmate came into town.
Oh, that's right.
Gave it to him good. Because right now, with the names that I have, I actually had to write down the years, and that helped me remember the chicks that I banged. 75 was the fat one. That was my first.
Very nice.
Yes. Then there was Nikki in 1977. and then the waitress at Pizza Hut in 79. By the way, the blank years doesn't mean I wasn't banging somebody. I had a chick I was banging.
I see.
Lisa, 1980, then a chick I dated in 82. Dated her all the way to 87. 1986, I banged my hairdresser and then her roommate.
Are they on there?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then a chick in 88, Wendy, and then 89, Kara, Kimberly, Ashley, Tiffany, and Lisa. 89 was a good year.
Yeah.
91, I banged Greg's ex-girlfriend. 94, Tiffany. 95, Rachel. 97, Julie. 99, Danny Sexton. Michelle, Bosnian chick, bondage chick, L.A. Le Mans, one of the sales chicks. Christy, dancer and lover boy limo, Mothra, and my high school sweetie.
Do you see how we went from normal chicks to...
Yes. Starts out with pizza in chick and then ends up with...
I was on radio the whole time, almost.
I just mean we go to porn chicks and to psycho people you don't know in the limos and things like that from chick at Pizza Hut. And
so right now I think I'm about 28, which I thought was a lot more than that. But there are a lot of chicks that I fooled around with that I didn't actually poke.
Yeah.
And we're not counting those.
Mm-mm.
There were chicks that wanted to have sex that I wouldn't because I didn't have a rubber. I specifically had one that tried to do it. I don't have any cooties. You don't know?
Yeah. I got the I'm allergic to latex thing one time. I went, well, so am I. Gotta go. And she was hot, too.
All right.
Made the right call.
Mm-hmm. And I have turned it down.
I'm not thinking. I'm not talking to you.
No, you're
I'm not. Thinking.
Okay.
All right.
Wait. Do it.
Just wait.
Do it. You'll never do it at home.
No, I won't.
This is the only time to do it.
And I found her on the internet through a search engine.
Excellent.
She's working at a radio station out of state.
Really?
Yeah, not on the air. But there was a picture of her. And I think in that picture, I printed it out. It's in the studio someplace. I forgot where I laid it out, but I think... Which hand is the wedding ring hand?
Left.
I think she's married then, because she had something... Because she's posed like this, and you can see something on the left hand. Well, that's the only reason they wear a ring there, right?
Well, that, or she wants listeners to think that she's married so she won't get hit on all the time.
No.
That's something women do, too.
Well, all the better. Then there's no... She's not going to turn you down. She's just married.
You got nothing to lose is the bottom line.
Yeah.
I don't want to know that she's married. I want her to be unhappy.
You're going
to
assume she's married anyway from the picture. So you might as well find out.
Well, look where you are now.
It goes south.
Where she is. I mean.
Yeah, that's true.
You haven't said on the air where she is yet, so I don't know.
It ain't a top 100 market.
Okay.
Well, where you think it is.
Yes.
And where it actually is.
Right.
It's not a top 200 market.
Ew.
Call her.
I don't want
to. Jesus. What's the worst thing that could happen?
I don't know.
I always play that out.
Everett, hand me a bottle.
Yeah.
Which one?
Just the one on top. Yeah, that's fine.
Obviously, she had interest in you.
Why?
We all dated. I mean, so she liked you. It's not like she never dated you or never liked you at all. There may be the same spark... From her.
Sure.
Is this the same chick that got closure from her ex-boyfriend?
Oh.
Oh.
And you want to call her?
She said they didn't do nothing.
Okay. In 3 days.
What?
Over the weekend, they didn't do nothing.
Excuse me. Yeah. Yes?
Just, that's 101 proof.
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, I'll stop then.
Sheesh.
Yeah, I need to stop because I may call her and start crying.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm married.
Come back to me.
Sure.
All right, here we go.
Maybe she'll get closure with you.
Yeah, that's what she needs. She needs to come back down here and get closure with me.
See? Use that line. That's witty.
You and I never got a chance to get closure. She actually, at one point, broke up with me through email.
Ooh. This is a cold-hearted woman. And you want her back.
I don't want her back. It's just one of those things.
Oh, you want to find out about her.
I'd take her back if she, mm-hmm. She would kill herself after we were done.
Yeah, sometimes they renege on those things.
Yeah. Even if you try and help them?
Yeah, especially if you try to help
them. You promise. I can't do that.
Oh, holy.
Yes, Chris.
Russell.
Yes.
You actually need to figure out, because I'm in this scenario, if she's married, most married women actually fantasize and masturbate about their ex-lovers, so you could leverage that and kind of see if she's been thinking about you.
All right. Yes, Veronica?
You have to call her. Her stomach will drop the minute she hears your voice. It'll be, you'll get such pleasure out of just completely stopping the brakes on her whole day.
Oh, yeah.
I promise her tummy will drop all the way to the floor when you say, hello.
Okay, good. Thanks.
There we go. See?
I didn't think about the harassing aspect.
There you go.
Now I can't wait.
All right. And you're a big shot in radio in the same business she's in?
Yeah.
Sure she's followed my career.
Stop giggling. You messed me up dialing. Sorry. All right, no more eating in the studio because everybody's clearing their throats from mucus floating. It's irritating. No more mucus generating food. See, I'm doing it.
I do it all the time, though.
Not as bad as when you eat. Or whoever it is you're blowing, quit it.
Quit it!
Please enter your account code now.
All right, I got to take part of this off the air. As soon as it starts ringing. Is it 4,200?
Correct.
Does it take this long to ring?
We're sorry. You have entered an invalid account code.
It was slower.
Please re-enter the code after the tone. Just thank you.
What?
It's a truck. You may have to reset the phone.
Why?
It's been doing something really strange. O'Malley has the problem, and the only way we can get it...
Oh, it's not going to ring. You mean just unplug it?
Unplug it for like 10 seconds.
How long does it take to reset? It's not coming back on.
It is.
See if it's working. Yes, Hillary?
Oh, hi, Russ. I was hoping you can help me with a problem.
Sure, go ahead.
I have this guy friend who told me that when guys stare at a girl, they're thinking about sleeping with her.
Yes.
Is that true?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Guys really think about that?
Yes.
With every hot girl they see?
Yes.
Every girl they see?
Every hot girl.
Moderately hot?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Do you have a problem with that?
What do I care?
No, I don't know. I'm shocked. And now I'm thinking about a couple of guys from the other day that, oh, gross.
Yes. That's what they're doing.
Really?
Yes.
Oh. Thank you,
there's,
I think.
There's one sales chick here in the building.
Yeah.
I just stand next to her just... Just in hopes that she'll bend over and I'll get a peek. You know what I'm talking about?
Absolutely.
Got the little freckles on her breast when she wears something with cleavage.
Mm-hmm.
My eyes are starting to water. Because you know who I'm talking about.
Absolutely.
Oh, man.
I know.
I'm going to let her squeeze an ooshie on me.
No,
I might.
No.
Why are you shocked about that, Hillary?
It's just gross. I mean,
it's not
some
gross.
Some guys that you see out there, it's, I mean, ew.
It's just appreciating your beauty.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
I don't know.
I don't care if it's your best friend's wife. When we look at them, we want to bang them.
Oh.
Everett's dating a really hot chick right now. She's really nice, and I never do anything. But, God, I'd love to get a hold of those nips. Her boobs are huge.
That's horrible. Well, what about a girl who's your friend?
No. I mean, God, that question threw me. We don't have women that are friends. We want to screw all our... If we call each other friends, we're doing that because we're laying the groundwork to get into your pants.
No.
Yes.
No, yes. There are guys and girls who can be friends.
No. Mm-mm. It's just all you are is a poke and waiting.
Just, oh, now that's...
Just wait for you to hit an emotional moment.
Or it's sad. I'm not even sure which.
And if you're hot, even as you walk through the mall, every guy's looking at you going, bend you over.
Yeah. We'll follow you through the store.
Yeah.
That's just crispy.
I was in Michael's one day, and some chick was in there buying college school supplies.
I understand.
Thank you. And she's bent over looking at stuff, squatted down looking at stuff on the very bottom rack, and you see the little fuzz on her back, mm-hmm. and just a little bit of butt crack. Right. I made that aisle like 12 times. I still think about that.
Isn't that funny?
Well, let me ask you this. Would you rather guys check you out or not check you out?
Oh, that's a tough one.
See?
Oh,
you
yeah.
You can't have it both ways.
Point. But it's still just a little, well, it's maybe it's the it's like you say only hot chicks. Well, it's kind of creepy when certain
it just,
guys
it depends on what mood
like
you're
that.
In, too. Because sometimes I've looked at some chicks that were borderline mm-hmm. that I thought would be just be cool as a you know, instead of, you know, unloading into a Kleenex.
Correct.
Yeah.
A throwaway.
Yeah. Thank you. That's my romantic side coming out. I have to go.
All right, let me try this again.
Okay.
Please enter your account code now.
I don't think it went through.
I don't either. This is getting damn irritating. Why is it I got to have an account? I want a phone line put in here that goes straight to whatever. Can I call out long distance from a request line?
Please enter your account code now. Sorry, you have entered.
Have O'Malley call and put it on hold.
Can you do that? All right. Do it now from the hotline. Here, taking the number. Go. I'll take this. How are we doing, Eddie? All right. Good, Gary.
Hey, Russ, how are you? What good. Cave has this girl been living in? That's what I want to know. And what about the girls that looking at guys? I mean, what, she never looked at a guy and wondered how good in bed he's going to be?
I don't know. I've never talked to chicks about that.
Nice tight buns or whatever.
Well, I've heard chicks say that, but I've never heard them talk about guy to like for him to pound me.
Yeah, actually sex. They don't. They look. They enjoy the body. They
I mean, I was just out with some girls the other night.
Is it ringing? I got to go.
No, your party's 4-digit extension. You may dial it now.
What's the extension?
490. Please dial
1116.
For the production.
It won't let me.
Here we go. I gotta take her off the air.
Okay. Hi. The second, if you'll leave a message, I'll call you right back. Thank you.
Do I leave a message?
Yes.
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 Hey, Julie, it's Russ in Dallas. Call me if you can. It's 4:23 in our time zone.
Central.
Yeah, Central Time. Call me at 214. Okay? That'll be swell. Thank you. Call me soon. Bye-bye. You still there? Pick up.
Thank you.
Hello?
It's getting embarrassing.
All right, I have to go now.
Please speak loud.
All right, I did.
There you go. Look at you. You feel better, don't you? I'm a little nervous.
She'll call you. What?
Why'd you give her my cell phone?
Because is your phone with you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Mine's in the car. And I want to give her the hotline. So when she calls, just tell her, da-da-da. Now I'm nervous.
Why?
I don't know. I can't explain this. It's just damn strange. You haven't ever made contact with an ex and just get nervous about it?
No. Can't say that I have.
Am I the only one here?
Yeah, I usually don't. I mean, once I'm done, I'm done.
Yeah. This is one you didn't really get done with, I guess.
No.
Even if she screwed you around a little bit.
You don't know that she screwed me around. I'm sure she had reason for everything that she did when she effed me.
Oh, Jesus. Here we go. Rationalization. This is not good.
Now, is this the one you were in the pickup truck standing looking over the fence?
Possibly.
That is definitely it.
It's also the same one where her ex-boyfriend came into town. She said, we never got closure. Can we just talk? Because we lived together, and then I moved out of Florida, moved back to Dallas. We didn't get a chance to talk. I just packed up my stuff. Can I have one evening and talk to him? And, of course, I said no. I went, if you meet him, it's over. It's done.
Mm-hmm.
3 months in a row, I said that.
Yeah. Is this the Barry, was it a Barry Manilow concert?
Yes.
Damn.
You're attracted to her unavailability.
That's exactly what it is, and I think that's the reason I get chicks, because yes. They know that I'm not really available.
You each seek out each other.
Interesting. As crazy as she's made you, you'd take her back.
Knowing that it will never work out.
Yeah, maybe she got better.
God.
But you don't really believe that.
Could happen.
In your heart of hearts, do you really think she's gotten better? Knowing human nature the way you do.
Maybe it was me. God, I'm going to slap you. Yeah, it was you standing at the fence while she was in there.
You don't know what was going on in there.
I don't know what was going on in there. I got a really good idea. If it's an ex-boyfriend, 3 nights in a row.
Was it really three total nights? Just till like 3 o'clock in the morning?
Okay. Well, look at him. Went home.
I still to this day can't believe I put up with it. I let one night go. Can we go to dinner? It's a group of people. Da da da. Then she tells me the next day, well, there were so many people there, we didn't get a chance to talk. And? Can we talk tonight? No! Then I told her, you call me at 10 o'clock when you guys are done. She don't call. 10 o'clock, 11, phone don't ring.
God, what a lesson. When did the phone ring?
Not until the next day.
That was the night.
You don't know.
I do know.
You don't know.
You know. Shen called up the next day.
Maybe she was sleepy.
That would be why her head was in his lap.
Yeah. Banging makes you tired.
Yeah. Yeah, that was the night I was standing looking over the back fence to see if I could see in the house. I honest to God almost climbed over. That's how nutty I got. I almost climbed over the fence and tried to look in the windows.
What would you have done if you'd seen him in full throw?
I probably would have actually walked through the glass door and strangled them both.
I know the feeling. I know the emotion.
Because when you get to that point, you really don't need to be anywhere around there because you're going to kill somebody.
And you want to sign up for more of this?
I'm not signing up for anything. I just looked up her, found out where she was on the internet, just looked into it, and that was it.
So what is the purpose in contacting her again?
I don't know.
And why are you nervous? You don't care.
Can we break? She call you? I shouldn't have left a phone number.
Why?
What if she don't ever call?
That didn't mean anything.
Yes, it does.
No, I mean, she should have never get the message.
Yes, shut up with that.
She'll call. No, she'll call just to say hi, if nothing else. How long did you guys date?
About a year. Year and a few months.
And at what point in that, I really have forgotten, did the ex-boyfriend come in?
Who knows?
Okay, I just didn't know if it was near the end, in the middle.
Nah,
first.
Let me think. I think that was September.
end of the summer of 97. Mm-hmm. We've been dating about 4 or 5 months.
About halfway in.
Of course, it was smooth sailing all the way up till then.
I can imagine. With a girl like that. So it was rocky. It was only 1 year.
She wasn't rocky the whole time.
Oh, Lord, who does this sound like?
Actually, we got a
Did you, don't you dare say it.
It was exactly, it was a relationship like you have with Joy.
No, it's not.
Where you have to rationalize that everything's fine. If you ever have to say, actually, we're getting along pretty good, that means that it's not normal.
We've had weekends that have been problems.
Well, so does everybody. Every time you have to say,
so does
if
everybody.
You have to point at a certain point in time and say, well, look at this, we got along then that means that's an anomaly. Well, yes?
Yes.
Do you and your new girlfriend ever have every good weekend? Every weekend's perfect.
Yes.
No, really? Well, you're not dating that long.
Well, I mean, we don't have the problems that you and Joy do, clearly.
Anyway. But now you had a relationship like that that only lasted a year, and you're ready to get back into it.
I'm not ready to get back into anything. I just
want to check on
her. I'm just curious. Because the relationship just ended weird.
Yeah.
And if there's a chance in hell to nail that one more time, I'm good with it.
Okay. Fair enough.
But it's not somebody you'd want to get in a relationship with again. I know better. Did she call yet? No?
If it's just a nailer, why are you nervous? Why are you feeling weird?
It's a radio bit. I'm milking it.
It's not. I can see your eyes.
Yeah, that boyish grin of yours is not a radio bit.
Mm-mm. Milking it.
Okay. We'll see when she calls.
Is it ringing?
Oh. Well, now he's going to do that to you all day. Look at his cell phone.
Maybe she's back at her desk now. I should call again.
Do not look pathetic.
What?
The first phone call is enough. She will call or she will not.
Yeah, second phone call is going to make her more likely to call.
It'll make her less
maybe
likely.
Maybe she ain't checked her voicemail yet.
Then, fine.
But then if she don't check it before she leaves for the weekend, she won't call till Monday.
She can call. He'll have his cell phone. Trey will have his cell phone all weekend. When she calls, she can say, give her some number for you. Or say, we'll call you on Monday.
I guess you could call and hang up if she doesn't answer. Anyway, she won't know you called the second time.
Yeah, we'll call her ID on a desk phone.
It's not going to be on it. Yeah, there's no caller ID.
Right.
And then if she answers, you're good.
Yeah. Did we call her?
Then she'll check your voice message later and go, why'd you call me twice? Within 10 minutes.
Okay, so I don't call her?
No.
All right. Do what?
Call her.
You're going
to
call her?
When she gets the number, if she wants to speak to you, she will call Trey's number. It will ring, and he can tell her to call back.
Yeah, but he's right. She may not have checked her voicemail, but she may be back at her desk.
Then we'll do it Monday. What's the hurry?
What?
You want him to be miserable all weekend, wondering if she's going to call?
Yeah. He's not in a relationship with this woman. Why would he be miserable?
Look at it. He wants to talk to her.
He just wants to bang her.
So
let it go. What difference is Monday going to make? How long has it been?
4.5, 5 years.
3 days won't make a difference.
Yeah, but you know how he gets when he's on?
Yeah. I want it now.
Baby with a rock.
Well, she's not going to be in town this
weekend. You said baby with a heart on?
No.
I don't think you can say that.
I said baby with a Rottweiler.
Baby with a Rottweiler.
Yeah.
How many times you ever see Rottweiler's feet sticking out of a baby's mouth? That'd be a funny picture.
It would.
To have a Rottweiler and a baby eating on it.
Yeah.
Time's up, bitch.
Jesus.
Hmm.
Don't look pathetic. Oh, for somebody you're not even dating. 3 days won't make a damn bit of difference, but if you call twice in 10 minutes.
I'm not calling.
Okay.
It's a bit.
Good.
The only reason I'm doing it on the air is just to kill time.
Okay.
Tired of war talk. Figured I'd look pathetic for an hour.
Mm. We've all done it.
Yeah, Tim?
Yeah. Hey. What you should do is call her, hit zero, see if it transfers you to operator, and have her paged.
Do they have a live operator there?
During working hours, but I think they close.
See, everybody wants me to talk to her.
Yeah.
Everybody's excited. The tension is insurmountable.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yeah, I could have used an R, I think. But
The tension is insurmountable.
Very good. Nice work.
I was just excited I got most of it out.
Yeah, it was very nice.
Thank you. Where's the R go?
Off in the middle.
Yeah.
Right before you mount.
It ain't silent?
Not usually.
Not even the French pronunciation?
Oh, sure.
Thank you. All right. We all set up for this thing? You want to lay money down on who would win this, since you and I aren't going to play, JD?
Yeah. No offense, Trey, but I'm going to have to go with one of the other two. As far as these are sixth grade questions.
Yeah.
Well, only because he went to more college. I'm going to say, I mean, smart-wise, I think they're equal, but as far as educated and knowing.
But think of how many different, I know you're going to go with Everett, but yeah. Think of how many different times something's come up, and Eddie's always known it, that's and not true. Only just a little bit, in depth. He's surprised. You can always tell when we get into a subject, mm-hmm. and I need some background information, I'm always going to twist to the right and see what Eddie's got.
True. He's very, very well read on world affairs and such. I just don't know which way these questions go. If they're named the planets, I don't know that he's into that. If it's world history, I think he's way
I think it's
that.
A little bit of everything.
I'm still I'm going to go with Everett.
All right.
It'll be close. I'm going to go with Everett.
I'm going with Eddie.
Okay. How much?
Do what, Eddie?
I'm not fast. I mean, as far as, like, actually hearing the question, comprehending it, and processing it, I'm rather slow.
Okay.
JD's right, though. You have a very broad fund of general knowledge.
Well, then here's what we'll do. Let me see. I don't know if this works or not. What? You were going to say something?
I was going to say, instead of using the buzzer, let's give them both 15 seconds to think about it. They both answer, and whoever's right wins. That way, if it's a speed issue, whoever's going to win, then.
Nah, we'll just try normal.
Okay.
All right, test your buzzer, Everett. Hang on, you got to reset it. All right, yours, Eddie. Trey, you in on this one?
Yeah.
All right. As we find the stupidest person on this show, obviously we've already limited JD and me, because there's no way I can answer any of these. All right, here we go. You going to keep scoring?
Yep.
You need to reset?
Yeah, okay. You do that? She call yet?
No.
Are you sure you got your phone on?
Positive.
Check it. Is it on?
Mm-hmm.
Is it on vibrate?
Mm-hmm.
Turn it on to ring. Is it on ring?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Good. Here we go.
All right.
Give the first five letters of the name Czechoslovakia. You know what I'm saying?
What is CZECH?
That's right. Probably Czechoslovakia. Slovakia.
There you are.
Thank you. What king was the father of Queen Elizabeth I? Everett.
Who's King Henry VIII?
Yeah. What do you call the first version of a composition?
What is a rough draft?
Yes. Is that her?
No.
Who is it?
I don't know. They hung up.
So it didn't register?
It was a 972 number.
Oh, okay.
It's one of your friends just jacking with Russ.
Which Brazilian city has the larger population?
What is Rio de Janeiro?
No.
Does he lose one now?
Yes.
Okay.
Come on, Eddie, you could do it. Think, focus, bigger than the show.
I thought you were going to give us options. I was waiting for the rest.
I couldn't say the other one. It looks like Sao Paulo.
Sao Paulo.
No, it doesn't have an N.
Sao Paulo.
Sao Paulo. You take that one?
Yes.
Eddie gets a point.
2-1.
What was the name? No, I'm starting again. What was the language of ancient Rome? Is that you, Eddie?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought I was resetting.
Are you buzzing in?
No.
Is anybody buzzing in? Everett.
What is Greek?
Nope. Of all people, you should know this one. Trey.
What is Latin?
Yes. There's one for Trey.
Fight up.
One apiece.
Give the contraction for the word, the words do not. Everett.
What is don't?
Is squid a vegetable, a fruit? Everett.
It is a meat, an animal. What is an animal?
Or a seafood. Trey.
It's a seafood.
Duh.
That's what you get for jumping ahead.
Yeah, you're right.
Trey pulls ahead.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Why do birds have very light bones? Everett.
What is so they can fly?
Yes.
So far, I haven't missed one. I just haven't answered.
You know them? You just not say?
It takes me a minute to register and then...
Shush. Is that her?
Something's wrong with my phone.
What's wrong with it?
I don't know. It keeps... It's rant. I mean, that was anonymous. That might have been her.
Mm-hmm.
She'll leave a it'll go to my voicemail.
Will it?
Yeah.
But it's not going to have my name. It's going to have his name, and she's going to hang up. She's going to think she's got the wrong number.
There's something else you can do.
What?
Call back.
Yes.
If you call back.
Yes.
Say, you know what that number I gave you?
Right.
That's a cell phone, and it's dead.
Yes.
Here's another number.
Okay.
That gives you an excuse to call back.
Is that a voicemail? What is it?
No, they were trying again, and then my phone.
That's got to be her.
Mm-hmm. Probably is.
Get her on the phone, Dan. Do you have the number? Take him the number. We need a break?
We can.
Do we need to?
Calm down. We're in the middle of a game.
What are you doing?
You want me to call her?
Yeah, call and see if that's her just right now. If that's her, give her the hotline.
Chick you hadn't talked to in how long?
It screwed you over?
Did I ask for any help?
Close.
Now's a really good time to shut up.
Okay.
Think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Dwell on it. Embrace it.
I will.
Dream. Do you want to leave a voicemail?
Yeah, give her the hotline number. Yeah.
Hi, Julian. This is Trey Trenholm. Russ Martin, I work with Russ, and he gave you my cell phone number. So why don't you call the hotline if you get this? 21.
Give it to her again.
214.
Did you give her the same number twice?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
That was probably her, and I missed it. Now she's not going to call. She's going home for the weekend. I'll be damned. On a grid map, where is the corner labeled A1? Top left. Trey.
Top left.
That's right. Who is the Greek god of music? Apollo, Ares, or Herpes?
Who's Apollo?
Yes.
I think you meant Hermes.
Whatever. Give the postal abbreviation for the state of New Mexico. Is that you, Eddie?
Yeah.
What?
NM.
Yeah. What's the official language of New Zealand? Eddie.
English.
Yes. What's the score?
Tied up 3 apiece.
All right. People once drove horseless carriages. What are they called today? Eddie.
Cars.
Yes. All right.
Eddie pulls ahead.
Yes. See? Is a flat land area close to a sea level called a plain or a plateau? Eddie.
Plateau. I mean plain.
Yes, plain. Plain is right.
Wait a minute.
He corrected himself before the buzzer got him. He gets the point.
Is he staring at the cards?
No, I was...
Oh, you can't see him. Can you see that from there?
I started thinking table. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
But he's had the laser vision.
Who did not have the right to own land? Everett.
Who are women and slaves? Hey, Eddie got to correct himself.
Rest of the question would probably help. Knights, vassals, or serfs? Eddie!
Vassals.
No. Trey?
Serfs.
Yes. The score.
Evie, Everett now has 2. Eddie and Trey are tied with 4.
Good.
Never.
Which is not a city in France? Paris? Paris or Brussels?
What is Brussels?
Who got that?
Me.
Okay.
Marseille.
Because I'd have said Marseille.
As soon as I saw it, I went, this ain't in me. This ain't in this. This is not my intelligence. Who said all roads lead to Rome? Was it Hannibal? Julius Caesar? Trey?
Julius Caesar.
Everett?
Who is that third guy you're about to say?
Yes. Is it Octavian?
Yes.
Whatever.
Close enough.
Oh, now you know.
I always wait for the end of the question.
Yes, well.
It's polite.
Yeah, it's really helpful, I'm finding out, too.
Which of Aesop's fables ends with the moral, slow and steady wins the race?
What is the tortoise and the hare?
Anyone else?
Oh, please.
What is the hare and the tortoise?
Yes.
Oh, okay. That's weak.
Are living things described as organic or inorganic?
Organic.
Yes, Eddie.
Wait a minute.
What?
How come mine rang in and then it cut out?
Because I was pushing the wrong one.
See?
Convenient, and he got the point.
You are such a cheater.
I'm not doing anything. We didn't bet any money.
All right.
Which makes cheating all the more pathetic.
Shush. Who was famous for the comedies? Screw that one. In what book does a poor boy become a prince and a prince become a poor boy?
The Prince and the Pauper.
Yes. By?
Was it Mark Twain? Mark Twain.
Yes, give him another point.
I'm not giving him another point. You're going,
you know what that means? And I believe I've seen Alex Trebek do it many times on Jeopardy. Some chick was fumfing around and he was going,
we need a break.
We really do badly.
All right, we'll do a couple more questions and wrap up this fabulous, fabulous bit, which I'm sure that will be featured on Best Of. Not on this show. Give it to Goldberg. He deserves it.
Oh!
Ow. Hi, Ken.
He's playing basketball. He made a three-pointer.
Was Benedict Arnold an American traitor or patriot? Everett.
What is a traitor?
Yes.
He was both. Huh?
I just says traitor on here. What is the popular name for our galaxy? Eddie.
Our galaxy.
What is the Milky Way?
Yes.
Back down to very close.
What's the score?
Right now, Eddie has 6, Everett has 5, Trey has 3.
All right, a couple more. If you fly from Tokyo to Honolulu, what ocean do you cross?
What is the Pacific?
Yes.
Head up.
Who was a powerful leader in Louisiana, Huey Long or Spiro Agnew? Trey.
Huey Long.
Yes. In astrology, what name is given to the sign of the lion? Trey.
What is Leo?
Which are composite numbers? 2, 4, 7, 8, and 10. Composite numbers. 2, 4, 7, 8, 10. Trey.
What is 2, 4, 8, and 10?
No. Anyone else? 4, 8, and 10. 2 and 7 are prime numbers.
Oh.
What living things are capable of photosynthesis?
What are plants?
Kind of plants.
Green plants.
Too late.
Eddie? What are green plants?
Yes.
No way.
Give that to him. I'm giving him a point.
Well, sure, if you're not going to play by the rules.
How dare you.
In what country did Margaret Thatcher become? Everett.
What is Great Britain? Or England?
Eddie.
That's amazing.
Eddie gets a point. It's England.
He doesn't get a point for that.
I got that one.
You're the biggest bunch of whiners I've ever played this game with.
All right.
Good God, man. Lose with a little dignity.
It's tied 770.
I know this is a sucky bit, but why does this intrigue me?
Because it's fun.
What planet is named for the Roman king of gods? The gods. Everett.
Jupiter.
Jupiter.
Yes, Jupiter is correct, Eddie.
I said it. You called on me.
He hit the wrong buzzer.
I hit my buzzer. What buzzer am I supposed to hit?
The one that rang was mine.
Yes, Eddie was the one that rang it. Eddie gets that one because the horse went off. Eddie's the horse. Everett's the moo. Trey's the pussy. This really shouldn't be that difficult. Just all focus.
It's not.
What body forms the center of the solar system? Eddie!
The sun.
Yes. What religious leader was born in Mecca around AD 570? Eddie!
Who is Muhammad?
Yes. What religious leader was born in Mecca around AD 570?
Who is Muhammad?
Sorry, Eddie. Are we really behind?
Yes.
Good. In what country are Montreal, Everest,
Canada,
Toronto, and Paris?
All in the same country.
Complete the analogy.
The analogy?
Yeah, one of those.
Okay.
Perspiration is to humans as transpiration is to...
What is plant?
Yes. What is Eddie's wife's first name? Eddie!
Actually, what is Jerry?
Is it Jerry?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
They
What's the score?
Is that on the questions?
Yes, right here. Please.
It is not.
What's the score?
Well, with all your finagling, Trey has 5, Everett had 9, Eddie had 10.
Thank you. Prove my point.
Sure you did.
We'll be back. Here, Everett Newton, J.D. Ryan, Dan O'Malley, Trey Trenholm. Yeah, life puts off today. The other thing that's sad is these are sixth grader questions.
Yes.
I didn't know the answer to any of these.
Oh, that's not true.
Flip over to one of these pages. All right, do this. Okay? There's the questions.
Okay.
The answers are there.
Gotcha.
Got it? Here. Go ahead.
What large hairy spider got its name from Toronto, Italy?
Spider monkey.
You know better.
Tarantula.
Very nice.
Yeah, easy. It's sick. Go ahead.
One for one.
All right.
How do you spell the second word in the title Star Trek?
T-R-E-K.
2 for 2.
Stop looking for the easy ones. Just go. Just start at the top and go down to one.
What food is Idaho famous for?
Potatoes. You're picking. Go ahead.
A stream or river that flows into another river is called what?
Tributary.
Very nice. Look for a hard one now. Name 3 American states that border on the Gulf of Mexico.
Texas, Louisiana, and Florida?
Yes. Mississippi and Alabama.
J.D. was pointing at his sack.
It does. It looks like a thing.
Yeah. Go ahead.
Name 1 country located on the Scandinavian Peninsula.
Venezuela.
Norway or Sweden would have been acceptable.
Sweden.
See, you know all these.
What is that, James Brown? Godfather of Soul? It ain't the Godfather of Soul. Is it really? What's that?
Me!
Godfather of Soul.
How you feel?
I feel good!
Da, 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 da.
got a brand new bag. Get on the good foot. Living in America. I'm right here and ready to get down.
Were you, I don't think we ever said, where are you playing tonight? Is it next stage?
Yes.
What time do you go on?
Well, I go on about 8:30.
And how long do you sweat?
I'm sorry?
How long do you play?
I don't know. It is how I feel. I like to enjoy myself, and most of all, I want the people to enjoy their stuff.
Do you still sweat like 6 or 7 pounds off when you're performing?
It's a high energy show. Nothing has changed. We just played for the U.S. Senate, which has never been done in history. We play in Europe. We have 200,000 to 300,000 people like the Beatles did years ago. So, you know, I'm glad we're getting back in America so people can see these kind of shows, because the kind of show we do, you don't see them no more. They were around years ago.
See, this is one of the few people that actually made it through the British invasion. Didn't affect his career at all.
Mm-hmm. Say that again.
Is this a bad phone connection?
I didn't hear you.
Godfather. Let me try this. Is that any better?
Yes.
Okay, good. You made it through the British invasion, didn't even phase your career at all.
Well, thank God I was able to keep on going, and thanks to people like you, and just thanks for a lot of good people.
Well, certainly one of the greatest performers I've ever seen in my life.
Yes, sir.
Do you still carry guns?
I want you to come on in and get down with us.
How was your trip when you came in?
It was fantastic. We flew direct from Washington, D.C.
They take your guns away?
And it was a great flight, and I'm ready to go.
What was I going to ask you?
Tell everybody Godfather's back, and we want to get down. Get on the good foot. Get up off of that thing. Sex machine. Let's party. Are you ready?
Now, let me ask you this. Your publicity people wouldn't let you come in the studio. How come is it you're not doing personal appearances anymore?
I'm sorry.
You're what?
Say that again.
I said your publicity people wouldn't let you come in the studio. They say
I don't know what they're doing, but I know one thing, that it was probably for the best. They want me to get all the rest I can, you know.
No, they said you get kind of wild. What is it you've done in the past?
All the shows I've always done.
Uh-huh.
Over and over again.
Uh-huh.
And all you got to do is come tonight and see it. You don't have to worry about what they say. Come and see yourself. How's that?
This ain't going to last much longer.
Okay.
All right.
I've been looking for you and you and you and you, and especially.
Yes.
And I'm so glad to be in this area.
And we're certainly,
I used to play Sherman.
Yes.
I used to play Dallas, Fort Worth. I mean, all this area, you know, Austin, San Antonio. I'm just glad to be back here, and I hope everybody is ready to get down and have some fun.
Do you have any fireworks in your act?
No, we don't do that. We do show business. We don't do, the gyro stuff, because that's too dangerous.
Yes, it is. Very dangerous.
I want to take care of people. That's what happened to those other kids the other night, doing that gyro stuff.
Yeah, you don't need none of that.
I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do a good show.
You Godfather, so.
With the respect.
I understand that.
And God bless America, and thank you for letting me call you.
Absolutely. I appreciate you calling.
Love you.
You're a crazy man.
No gyrotechnics.
I had the gyro take me one time. My head blew up.
Now you wonder why they don't let him come in the studio.
I ain't in town. Yeah. I ain't in Austin. I ain't in San Antonio. I don't know where the hell I am right now. All I know, Pop got a brand new bag. I got my son right here with me. Hey, Lamont. Call these people.
I could have done a better interview faking it myself.
Yeah.
Well, that ain't him calling back, is it? Is that Julie? Who's on the hotline? What?
Johnny from Operation Kindness.
What does she want?
She was saying she's in Michigan and when's a good time to call in.
Oh. Michigan. They an hour ahead of us?
Yes.
Yeah. Tell her about an hour and 45 minutes. That'll throw her off. Well, now we know why they wouldn't let him come in the studio.
Yep.
What was that? About a minute and a half?
I marked it down. It was a total of 3.
3 minutes.
3 minutes.
And most of that, hang on. Sorry.
Oh.
That one was so stinky, I didn't want to smell it.
God.
I like the way he couldn't hear some of the questions.
Yes. Well, he's old, too.
He heard some of the questions.
Yes. Isn't it funny? He heard the questions he wanted to answer.
Yeah.
How was your flight?
My flight was really good. I flew all the way in, and I'm here right now, and I'm ready to play for the people. Proud of the people. Who?
Thank you.
Well, we can do news now. That certainly was worth waiting for all week. Another fine, fine guest you booked, Trey. Is that really James Brown?
That was really James Brown.
He obviously got in a studio someplace and wigged out. And they finally said, you know what, he's too much of a liability.
Probably several times.
I would love for him to do that here. That would have been great. Running around in circles.
Mm-hmm.
Take your hair off. Pull the teeth out.
Now, I got an email from somebody that said, evidently he did Stern.
Mm-hmm.
And seemed very uncomfortable with some of the questions. Like, couldn't get out of there, so.
Maybe somebody, no. There's no way anybody would find out about what we do to people.
No.
Because we have shot him.
Mm-hmm. He just shot back.
Mm-hmm.
No, the people in New York.
Yeah, we come in with, you know, our fake blank gun.
Right, yeah.
Before we could even get it out, I go, hey, look at this!
Dead white boy.
What were you going to say?
The people in New York, I mean, they don't know us from anything. I mean, as far as what we do, they know the show, they know the ratings. But they, I mean,
they don't know that we shoot guests.
Right.
Yeah.
And they automatically said no in-person appearances.
Mm. Well, how too bad. Because he seemed quite delightful.
Yes.
Very effervescent.
Was.
Probably drunk.
Mm-mm.
Well, then let's do news.
Okay.
I need a respite.
Okay, we can do that.
Interviews like that drain me. I use every ounce of my entertainment persona.
Right.
To carry that interview.
I got
it. Let me call in. I got to go. The troopers are here.
JD's what?
Yeah, Caleb?
Russ?
Yes.
I just wondered what happened with the sheet with JD.
What sheet?
Did you hold a black light to it?
Oh, what happened with that? Did I give it to Chloe and we never saw it again?
It was clean.
No, I don't think it was.
It was totally clean. You saw it.
I didn't see anything. Did we bring it in here?
I think we gave it. No, I didn't do it on there. I can find Chloe if you want me to.
Yeah, it's his birthday, too.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
You know, you can get a luminol that the CSI use and put it on there.
Yes. Okay, we'll do that. Thank you. All right. What?
Lost for blood.
Yeah, I don't care. Make any difference, and I'm not menstruating. Somebody want to make spray some Lysol because there's a poot front moving in.
Oh, jeez. Daddy hell.
It's a turnip soup I've been eating.
It's very tasty, but could you eat it on the weekends?
I don't think I ate any this week. It seems to stick with you for 4 or 5 days.
Great.
Low carbs. You throw in some chicken, high protein.
It is very good. I've had it. It's very spicy.
All right. 521, J.D. Ryan's on the new 105.3 FM Talk. Or what?
The Live 105.3.
That.
To Talk to Rocks, Texas. Thanks, Russ. Brought to us by SBC Communications and by Expedia.com. They have breaking news. Kuwait City's had an explosion. So that's all the details.
An explosion? They were attacked or what?
They haven't said if it's a missile or explosion yet, or if it's a bomb or an actual missile. It's just breaking on CNN.
Okay.
Iraq's information minister said at least 58 people were killed today in a crowded market in northwest Baghdad, what local officials are calling a coalition bombing. The market was strewn with wreckage, and there were bloodstains on the sidewalk. State Department said on Friday it had information that the Iraqi intelligence officers planned terrorist attacks against the U.S. interests in two foreign countries. In both cases, the operatives were arrested, terroristic material was confiscated, and the attack was not carried out. Speaking of terrorist attacks, with war abroad and the threat of terror ever present at home, truckers are now on a heightened state of alert. Those hauling flammable cargo especially watchful for any potential problems. Police warned that terrorists could load explosives into empty trailers and ram them into buildings and landmarks.
Didn't they have a tanker truck go missing one day this week? Never mind, I must have made that up.
Okay. I went to the airport today, and they stop you now before you can get your little ticket about 50 feet back, and then just look in your car. I don't know what that's supposed to do, but
it's a cursory check.
I guess. I mean, they didn't search the car. They just looked in it. If I had something under the seat, they wouldn't have seen it.
That's why it's called a cursory check.
I see.
It's not a very good one.
I got
good
you.
Ones are called good checks.
Okay. Yeah, they were real clever. I have a truck. They looked in the bed.
Yeah.
That's right behind it.
Of course.
Texas Lotto jackpot may soon be getting bigger, but the chances of winning getting smaller. The three-member Texas Lotto Commission yesterday approved a new game in which players will choose five numbers from a field of 44, and a second drawing choose a bonus ball, again, from 44 numbers. Chances of correctly picking all six numbers, 1 in 47 million, compared to 1 in 25 million in the current game. They'll be on sale March the 4th. Michael Moore may have pissed off a lot of folks with the Oscar night situation. But he's moving quickly to cash in on the controversy. He just signed a deal with Mel Gibson's Icon Productions to produce a documentary called Fahrenheit 9/11, which he claims will explain why the U.S. has become a target for terrorism and will also depict alleged interactions between two generations of the Bush and Bin Laden families.
Somebody said on his website he explained who the audience was actually booing.
Oh, it wasn't him?
That's what he let me see if I can find it really quick. Let's see. I'd like to thank the Vatican. Hold on a second. What is this? Word of advice to future Oscar winners. Don't begin Oscar day by going to church. That's where I found myself this past Sunday morning at the Church of the Good Shepherd on Santa Monica Boulevard, at Mass with my sister and my dad. My problem with the Catholic Mass is that sometimes I find my mind wandering and I hear something the priest says and I start thinking all these crazy thoughts like, it is wrong to kill people, and then you're not allowed to use violence upon another human being unless it's in true self-defense. Dang, shut up. Let's see if it's on here. Men are stupid. Liberal. They all agreed. Dying Lane. Aha.
Mm-hmm.
Moments later, Diane Lane opened the envelope and announced the winner, Bowling for Columbine. The entire main floor rose to its feet for a standing ovation. Fat bastard is full of fat bastard. Entire floor raises feet, standing ovation. I was immeasurably moved and humbled as I motioned for the other nominees to join my wife and me on stage. I then said what I'd been saying all week at those other award ceremonies. I guess a few other people had heard me say those things, because before I had finished my first sentence about the fictitious president, a couple of men, some reported it was stagehands just to the left of me, near a microphone, started some loud yelling. Then a group in the upper balcony joined in. What was so confusing to me, as I continued with my remarks, was that I could hear this noise, but looking out on the main floor, I didn't see a single person booing. But then the majority in the balcony, who were in support of my remarks, started booing the booers.
Oh, that you were booing.
Of course. So, they were actually showing their disapproval of the people that were disapproving of him.
Yeah, that's why the music came up really loud and they started backing the microphone down off.
That's a good spin on that.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it.
No. Because when you did cutaways, they did cutaways to people in the audience, you could just see that sourpuss look like he's not doing this.
Well, they showed people in the audience and clearly they were not pleased.
Mm-hmm. I don't see anything else on here. Anyway, it's on his website, michaelmoore.com. You still email media inquiries. Hey, did you get a hold of him? Did you invite him on the show?
Yes.
And what did they say?
I've got no response. Mm-hmm. I emailed him and told him that he thought he was a brilliant director, that you are strongly against the war. Against
did you email him or his media company?
It says media. It comes up media at michaelmoore.com.
So that wouldn't be to him. That would be to his media people.
I mean, yes.
Okay. Yes, we're big Michael Moore supporters.
That you didn't like Governor Bush either?
Mm-mm.
And
can't stand him. Makes me sick to even say his name.
That you were strongly for tougher gun legislation.
Am I? Is that what Bowling
for Columbine? Absolutely.
Yes. I love gun registration.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
So I lied as much as I possibly could.
Perfect. Why don't you call and see if you get James Brown on again? And you know what? Call. Just call him and go, hey, when's James going to call? Because I guarantee he'll forget he's already called in. Yeah. Hey, it's going to be in Dallas. Call him again. Go ahead. Call him.
I'll start the process.
Just call and say we're ready for Mr. Brown now. I just want to know what they say. And check your voicemail, see if Julie called. Okay. Go ahead.
Now, the operation in Iraq is going pretty well, but there's a gentleman that wants to step in. Speaking of boneheads, Jesse Jackson wants a truce. He wants a truce so that food and medicine can be delivered to Iraqi civilians.
That ain't why he wants a truce. Well, he wants to go in there and get some Iraqi food.
So that he and other religious leaders can visit the POWs. The U.S. ambassador to the U.N. said, mm-mm, because at this point, the best way to deliver aid to the Iraqis is for us to get Saddam out of power. And when CNN canceled Connie Chung's show on Monday, they assumed she would stay at CNN in some capacity. She walked. She also walked away from $2 million. She was in the middle of a two-year, $4 million contract. Don't worry, she'll be okay. Maury, of course, Povich, making $7 million a year off the Maury Povich show.
I bet she goes back to NBC.
They'll be okay. You think?
Isn't that where she left?
Yeah.
Get her some Tom Brokaw.
Mm-hmm. She's irritating.
She's funny looking.
I know. I can't watch her.
Some Asian women age really well. Mm-hmm. Well, she's aging really well. She's just funny. Just a strange look about her.
It's an odd, yeah.
I don't know how Maury climbs on top of that.
He loves her.
Long time.
Nice. Okay. A funny tune came out recently by a New York songwriter, Stephen Lynch. It's called Kill a Kitten. It has angered animal cruelty activists who want to keep him from performing in Annapolis this spring. Tickets went on sale last month. Tavern managers is basically getting all kinds of angry calls for lines like this in the Kill a Kitten song. When the game of life makes you feel like quitting, it helps a lot if you kill a kitten. Mark my words, because from where I'm sitting, you can't go wrong if you kill a kitten. Flush it down the can, hit it with your van, drown it in the lake, bake a kitty cake. Killing kittens isn't easy, and if the thought makes you feel queasy, grab a pitchfork from the shed and kill a puppy dog instead.
So they're like a Seuss book that didn't make it.
Yeah, basically. They're very up in arms about that.
Tough.
Just cats. That's right. There's news and information. I'm J.D. Ryan on Live 105.3, The Talk with Rocks, Texas.
Check on traffic. It's Craig St. James.
Well, good afternoon. This report brought to you by Tylock Eye and Laser Centers, as well as Car Toys. And if you're in Irving on westbound Highway 183, right at Story Road, got an accident that's on the right shoulder, but with onlooker slowdowns, you're slow all the way from Texas Stadium. Dallas, northbound 35 Stimmons Freeway, just past Walnut Hill, still have a bad accident there. This time only the right lane is blocked, but still you're slow from Mockingbird. Slow on Loop 12 by 114 in Texas Stadium as well, so expect that one. Northbound Loop 12, right by 35, yeah. Run by 35E. Hey, it's your show. You interrupt me, I'm going to have to stop for you. Hey, got a disabled truck. It's blocking the left center lane. And one more problem. Bedford, westbound 183 at Central. Got an accident with the left lane blocked. This traffic brought to you by Blockbuster. Also brought to you by the 2003 Chevy Trailblazer. Looking to conquer almost any scenario? Get inside the powerful 275 horsepower Chevy Trailblazer and make it happen. See the 2003 Trailblazer at your local Chevy dealer today. And I'm Craig St. James with traffic on Live 105.3, The Talk That Rocks, Texas.
Thank you, Craig. All right. Cool over the weekend. 37 for below tonight. Maybe down here freezing by tomorrow night. Mid-50s tomorrow. We have 51 degrees right now at Live 105.3. Three, The Talk That Rocks, Texas.
He's not very good at that.
He doesn't know what you're doing.
No.
He thinks everybody hears you.
Oh. Well, that's too bad.
Yes, it was.
All right, here comes Chloe. All right, what's the story? Did you ever do the black light on the sheets when JD stayed at my house?
Thanks for reminding me.
What's the matter with you?
No, I'm just saying, just remembering that, because when I checked it, yes, I did find a little dribble.
You did not.
And, you know, yes, make I did. I swear. And then when I took the black light away,
right,
there was a little, it was kind of tan, kind of brown.
No.
And
did you send him that?
No, I didn't send him anything.
Chloe, you know better.
We don't know better.
Yes,
you're an old man. You slept on my couch.
An old man, and I didn't dribble. You're more likely to dribble than I am. Edward's more likely to dribble than I am.
Why?
Because he has that iliac thing.
He ain't got his iliac thing. They took his iliac out.
Then that's the problem.
Now that his iliac's out, he ain't got no tenth and gyrotation. Gyrotation.
Well, how do you know when you're asleep, you know?
Yeah, you don't have control of your seepage.
You seep. You know what? Let's do one with you and see who seeps.
First of all, it's my furniture.
That's fine.
I'm just saying. I can seep all I want. You slept naked on my couch.
I didn't seep on anything.
Seep, you seep, seep. Better. It seeped. There was seepage it up. On it, and I was sure. Icked out because I actually touched it.
Sure. See? Not only did you seep out your weenie.
I believe you. I didn't seep out the... I don't think I would know that, thank you.
Why would you know?
Eventually, well, you sleep in the same sheets night after night, there would be something.
You don't there. Wash your sheets?
Not every day. Do you? Every single day you wash your sheets. That's what
I have somebody wash them for me.
Every single day.
They come in and wash my sheets.
In a hotel, maybe.
Yeah. That's why I'm trying to run up my power fitness. That's one time I had a big fire. Oh, the kill phone.
Hey. If I work on this, I can get this James.
You got to be real close. On the phone, I think they'd be very convincing.
You think?
Yeah.
You try it.
Well, the tape back will play him, and then we'll play you. I think we're going to find him.
I got to dial 9 on this?
No.
What's hotline number?
I don't know.
Nobody knows the hotline?
I'll just call the request line.
I'll move it.
All right, I got it.
I said I got lonely. I want to call back. See what's going on.
See?
I said he's in a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
I'd love being in Dallas.
You enjoy the scenery so far in Dallas?
I love the scenery. Mm-hmm. I love to give me some hot women and some guns.
How's the show going to be tomorrow or tonight?
It'll be great. I'm going to get out there. I'm going to sing. I'm going to dance.
Do you have any pyrotechnics in the show?
No, ain't got no gyrotechnics. We had gyrotechnics one time. Burn up four people.
Yeah, I see.
Burn them up.
I see.
Burn them from the bottom up. And burn. Burn up.
What are we going to be hearing in the show tonight?
Funny music. I sing music. I want to sing now. Same crap I've been singing for 35 years. I ain't coming up with nothing new.
Still carry guns?
Yeah, I shot a white man out the front door. I took his wife. I got out of the room right now.
Can you tell us why you had that police chase that time?
Because they chased me. That's what you do when you're black. You run from the police. You don't stop. And you stop, they catch you.
But you shot up your own house.
I meant it.
Why did you shoot your wife's minks and furs?
I wasn't sure they did. I walked in the house, yeah. And I see these wheels laying all over the house.
I
went, damn, they dance. I threw it in the front yard, and I shot it. Oh, I got brand new bag. Is this Austin?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, welcome to Austin. You have a wonderful time. Thanks for talking with us today, James.
Hey, it's been a good time. Is that all the time?
We'll see you at the next stage tonight. Damn.
It's too bad the funniest line I had to hit the delay. Yeah.
I've got an extra pair of tickets if anybody wants a pair of tickets in the show.
Go see James?
Yeah, tonight.
Oh, we got to shoot Happy the Clown.
I don't. I'll go.
You want to go?
I'll go.
I've got an extra pair of tickets. So, they're all yours.
Thank you.
You going to go, really?
I'd like to.
It's got
to
be a good... No, I don't know. We don't need you.
It's Grand Prairie. It's by my house.
It's got to be a good show.
You know it is. Next Stage is a great venue, too. It really is. Cool place to see shows.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody else big going out there?
I don't have a list in front of me. They have some bigger acts, some big acts coming, yes.
Okay. Shot up his own house.
Why is that illegal? Why are they cops?
Why is that illegal, Everett?
Well, probably disorderly conduct.
Why? You just shooting your own house?
Discharging a firearm or, you know, just something we try to avoid.
But your own property, your own house, land that you bought, you own everything. Why can't you shoot up your own house? I'm mad at it.
Well, I think that's sort of behavior that is likely to cause a breach of the peace.
Oh. All right. Disorderly conduct.
Yes, discharging a firearm within city limits.
Well, I can see them arresting him for killing his wife's clothes in the front yard.
Yes.
And running from the cops. Across state lines. Had to shoot his tires out.
You know, he was talking to himself the whole time.
Yeah. I ain't talking to any damn cop. I don't stand there like, I got a concert. I got to be there. Eat it. Yeah.
You grunted on my couch.
I did not.
Chloe found dribble.
I really did, JD. I don't want to see it.
You're not just dribbling out the front end. You've got problems on both ends.
Out of your mind.
You're bicoastal.
Yes.
Hush. I must see it.
I think it was flaky, too.
How very sad.
It was flaky, too.
I think it was flaky.
I'm sure it was. Like a crescent roll.
Was it the white or the brown?
No, the white stuff.
Oh. Well, we had the sheet sitting back there for so long.
Yeah, maybe some toe jam.
Yes.
I don't think the story needs any help, Clark. What are you doing for your birthday today?
Going tonight to Jack Astor's in Plano.
You going to work?
Going to work and play at the same time, so it's going to be fine. So come
maybe
on
if
out.
Maybe we get done with the movie early, we'll come
yeah,
by.
Come on out. Seriously, be
what
fun.
What time?
9 to midnight.
Oh, I got to call my dad. Today's his birthday, too.
Call him.
That's the way I remember clothes, because it's my dad's.
And thank you for the very kind e-card.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Send him an e-card.
Yeah. And did you run out and get you a Coke and a
Not yet. I'll just work on that tonight. So. Yeah. So, thanks. I appreciate it.
All right. Chloe from our promotions department. Trying to see if I wrote his number down. We just did news, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, let me see what this. Yeah, Sean?
Hey, Russ. I got a question, man.
All right.
Well, you're always talking about how America's behind the war and everything, and if that's the case, then why is there so many protests?
Because they don't want the war.
Well, apparently you say that everybody's behind it.
There
but
is.
It seems like to me what I see on TV is everybody's against it.
Well, you're just seeing the anti-war protest. There's no reason for us to protest because we got our way.
Pretty good point, yes.
Yeah.
I don't know, man. It just doesn't sound to me like this country's behind everything.
The polls are consistent. CNN does a poll every single day, and without fail, it has been right at or around 70%.
Yeah. When you get your way, you don't go out and protest. Mm-mm. We wanted the war. We got it. We're all happy. How many people you see protesting? Let's say you've seen 100,000. Would that be fair?
Yeah.
How many people in this country?
Oh, million.
250 million.
Yes.
Plus.
Thank you. Nobody else is out there because everybody else, we're happy with the fact that we got a war. There's no reason for us to go out and hold up signs.
Mm-hmm.
It would be a waste.
Oh.
Thank you.
Okay.
And thanks. By the way, did you call him Governor Bush?
Excuse me?
Never mind. Thinking about Michael Moore. We should have, what do you call it when you're for it? Like a, not,
pro-war?
Yeah, but they call it something else.
What do you call it when you're what?
Well, you want to go out and just, I don't know, just, it's just a rally, isn't it?
Civil disobedience.
No, not when you're going to get arrested. We should go out and have a rally.
Yeah, the rally, yeah.
He's right, not that many people are going out just to show support. But like I said, there's really no reason for us to go out because we're getting what we wanted.
They've had a few, right. Actually.
Yeah.
Pro rally. And a lot of people have shown up. It's been very selected cities, but yeah. A couple of different, yeah. People.
Yes.
Well put.
Thank you. Very articulate.
I tried.
All right, I found my dad's number. I'm lucky I get his voicemail.
Out of here. Out of town.
Wishing my happy birthday like James Brown.
Hey! Hey, Riley!
Please enter your account code now.
Oh, hell, I hit the wrong one.
Hey, James Brown, I like, we have
please
birthday.
Enter your account code now.
Oh, for him, it goes through. Come on. Voicemail. Let's get some voicemail.
Hi, this is Rusty. Leave a message and I'll get back to you. Thanks.
Elvis. Hey, it's me. Let's see, I don't know the hotline number. It's probably on your caller ID. Call me back when you get this. And I wish you a happy birthday. Okay? Bye.
Good. Boy, the love just oozes.
What do you want me to say?
How about, hey, Dad, hope you're having a great day. It's your son.
He's
going to,
when he calls back, I'll tell him all of that stuff.
Okay.
If it calls back, don't answer the hotline.
Could be your girlfriend.
Yeah, answer the hotline. Oh, great. Lady or the Tiger.
Exactly.
The hotline rings.
Feast or famine.
Swell. Yes, David.
Buddy.
Yes, sir.
How about a Born to Raise Hell party?
Well, that'd be a good idea.
We need some place big enough to hold it. I guess we could try Jay Gilligan's again.
How about Oak Cliff?
They have Born to Raise Hell parties every night.
Yeah, Jay Gillen's is big, and it's in the middle of Dallas and Fort Worth.
I'm going to do the last White Trash party. Was it October?
Yes.
Yeah. I hear it was a good one.
Mm-hmm. You enjoyed yourself.
October, November, December, January, February, March. Nah, it's not soon enough to, long enough to do a White Trash party. I was going to say, if we could combine the two, now would be a good time. Yes, did you have something to say?
Born to Raise Hell party?
Yes, what about it?
That's something you want to do?
I don't know. We're just discussing it.
Born to Raise Hell phone party.
Phone party. I don't know. The phone party didn't go over too well last time. I don't think most people got a handle on it. We had a great time. All you got to do is look at the pictures on my website.
It was a blast. It was a little...
Wasn't it cool?
It was kind of cool out.
That night.
Yeah. But get somebody in sales on it. See if they can find a place. Obviously, this war is going to be going on a lot longer than the government anticipated. They asked Bush today during a press conference, and he just kind of paused. You could tell he was getting pissed. He goes, it's over when it's over. It's not a direct quote, but that's what he meant. So I'm sure we got a little bit of time to set this up.
Well, do you want to do it at Jay Gilligan's?
Yeah, just like I said,
okay.
Put sales on it. Siebert's got these salespeople jumping around. Mm-hmm. I suggested a client last week. That day, they had already sent a salesperson out there to talk to him. The people doing the transmission work on the Mach 5.
Oh, yeah.
I went, they've worked on the car almost like three or four people's cars in this building. I've let them work on the Batmobile and the Mach 5. Obviously, that would be a good client. I think it was before 1 o'clock that day they had already sent out a salesperson.
They're afraid of the Seabird.
Yeah, because he's firing everybody just as he walks down the hall. It's like Father Death.
Did you see the new employee list that came out today?
No.
You remember it used to be on that big long sheet of paper? It's on an 8.5 by 11 now.
I'm surprised it's not on a business card.
And it's not full.
Yeah.
The Grim Seabird.
Yeah. Nobody wants to go to his office.
No.
I also heard that he kept his office locked yesterday while the vice president of the regional VP guy was here.
So he wouldn't get his pants.
He's worried about us coming in and getting his drawers. I swear to God, if I could have got his pants, I'd have left him in there with Ongaro for hours.
I would.
Yes, Vega?
Hey, Russ.
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, you got to have it done at Fair Park, brother, so Big Ted can watch all of us. You know what I'm saying?
I don't think Fair Park would let us do it out there.
Probably not.
Got to be some place that would make money off of it.
Yo, just think, man. Just think. We can get Emmitt Smith there, the biggest, big old nigga hand.
He could direct traffic.
Oh, Jesus.
Even the blind people are saying great big hands.
I know.
There's a scene in Happy the Clown where that actually comes up. I can't wait to shoot that one. That's the scene that opens the movie. Oh, that scene and the one we're shooting tonight, I think, are the two classics.
I think you're right.
And that's just in the course of half the movie. What is this going to cut down to be, about half an hour?
A little over half.
Okay. There are four really good gags in the first half. I'm happy with the way it turned out. And now we don't got a bunch of turds shooting for us. Oh, by the way, did you know that the Terry Real guy called Trey and said if we don't take his letter down off Happy the Clown, the one where he sent me letters saying we were full of crap, that he's going to sue.
Good. That made Edwards' day.
Yeah.
Have him call me.
He sent the email to me, and now it's posted. What's he going to sue?
I have no idea. I mean, clearly it's something that he wrote. He sent to you.
Yes.
There's nothing untruthful about it.
No. In fact, as you read the emails back and forth, I was being damn nice about it. Only because they were going to help us. They were doing it for free. We're going to raise money for the foundation. There's also, did Chris post that other email?
Yes.
There's the other email that he sent where they didn't want to work. The crew decided that they didn't want to work on the thing if the money went to the police and fire foundation. Because policemen and firemen have insurance. Animals don't. So that email is posted if you'd like to enjoy that. HappyTheClown.com.
Well, he has to have a reasonable expectation that if he sends you an email like that, you being who you are,
right,
you're going to publicize it.
when you send something to a radio station, it becomes, it goes into the public file.
Absolutely.
These things are printed out and they go into the public file.
Sure.
So it becomes the property of the radio station. If anybody wanted to come up here and read the letter, they could.
But there's no need for that.
No, because it's on the internet. Yes, Raquel.
Hey, what's up?
No.
Nothing much, huh?
Mm-mm.
Hey, I saw your speed racer the other day.
Where was that?
Gorgeous.
Where?
Over at the shop. I don't know if you want me to say it on the air or not.
Where was it?
The speed racer.
Well, it was either at the transmission shop or the auto shop.
Well, it was by both of them, and I can tell you the location if you want me to. I just didn't know if you wanted me to say on the
air. Nah, you don't have to, because I didn't get nothing for free. I got a deal at Eagle. I don't know if I got a deal at the other place.
Oh, okay. But anyway, I was looking it over. It's very nice. What kind of Corvette body style is it on?
It's a 93 Corvette.
93?
Mm-hmm.
With a pearlescent white. Very pretty.
Mm-hmm.
Never seen it before, so it was really quite an experience, and I kind of liked it a lot. I was wondering if you were willing to maybe sell it, if you know, for the right price.
Make me an offer.
Okay. Well, I'm sure you haven't put this much into it, but I don't really have the time, you know, to do the effort. So I was thinking maybe $200 or $250.
Meet me at 7 o'clock. I'll bring the pink slip.
I'm sorry?
I'll bring the title.
Okay.
Bring a cashier's check.
Well, unfortunately, the cashier's check isn't going to be tonight.
Okay.
The banks are all closed.
Yes. I'm running it pretty close to what I actually have into the car, but I certainly would like for you to have it if you enjoy it that much for $250,000.
Okay.
All right.
Do you have paperwork to show what you have put into the car?
Yes, I absolutely do. I will by tonight.
Okay. Would
where are you going to get that much money?
Well, I have some on my own, and
what do you do?
I'd rather not say.
Where do you dance?
I don't. I used to. I don't anymore.
Why is that so easy to spot?
I don't know. You're good at it, though.
I'm sorry.
So, how much money do you actually have in cash? By the way, if you check the windshield when you walk past the car, it didn't say on there, we tote the note. So I'm not going to carry your loan.
No, I understand that completely. If I were to get a loan for the rest of the amount, the bank would take care of that for me.
See, this would work
right
out.
Right now, I'm sorry?
Yes. I'll put you on hold, and Dan will get your information. She ain't got $250,000. Mm-hmm. But I am going to need room for the second Batmobile in the garage.
Yes, you are. What is the time frame on that?
Mark thinks he's going to have it done in another 6 weeks.
Wow, that quick. Of course, this is Mark time.
Well, he's been working on it for a while. He didn't just start it. He started on it right after. Yeah, you're right. It's Mark time.
Russ.
Yeah. Well, this is his second one, and he's worked out. It's always easier when you build something the second time. Be a couple of years. I'm sure. I'm in no rush. I already have one.
Right.
I'm just paranoid when I take it out, because if you get hit, you can't call Ford and go, hey, I need a left front fender for a 1966 Batmobile.
Mm-mm.
It's got to go back to California and be repaired. If you're the person that ever hits me, I would immediately get out of your car and kill yourself. Strangulation is preferable.
I told you I had that dream, man.
Then you backed into it?
I backed into it. Like the day before I got here, I said, oh, I woke up going, ah! Oh, thank God. That was terrible.
That's why I drive it so safely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure you do. Dragging up and down the tollway.
The tollway is a nice straightaway. You can see for miles what's ahead.
What about Beltline?
Shut up.
And the service road. Always. People tuning in and turning in and out. Man. You're dogging it. You're racing. That's not safe.
He revved his engine at me. Oh, I found out what that car was on the tollway last weekend. Mm. You know, the one, because it was just a Buick. Mm-hmm. And then he stomped on it, and the car took off.
Mm-hmm.
It was a Grand National.
Never heard of it.
I think it's supposed to be a turbocharged 6.
Oh.
It was damn quick off the line.
But you beat it in the long run. With the red lights blaring.
Also, when he got a little ways ahead,
mm-hmm.
he might have hit the siren a little bit. So he thought a cop was coming.
That's impersonating officer.
I didn't pull him over.
I went past it, yes. God. What's the matter with you people?
You stink.
You turnip toots are wearing us out.
Sorry. Well, then we'll take a break here. Everybody can go out and...
breathe.
Breathe. Yeah. Do we need a break here? Okay. All right. We'll come back. More stimulating talk.
Mm-hmm.
Not here. I missed it. Where was that plane landing? Where his gear was up?
Meacham.
Did that just now happen?
Yeah.
Just
a little bit ago.
They didn't say why his gear wouldn't come down?
Yeah.
Not mechanical.
Perfect landing, though. Right down the center of the runway.
It's just like that other one from last year.
Yeah.
Where the guy's gear wouldn't come down. What do they need wheels for? They seem to be slick every time.
Taking off like that's a bitch.
They spark.
Yeah, they spark. And the propellers don't turn. Small detail.
Why don't propellers turn?
Because the propellers are touching the ground at that point.
Oh. Well, good for him.
Yeah. Yeah.
Surprised that thing didn't smoke.
You're going to get a little bit of smoke just from the metal rubbing the concrete, but it like that, as long as the tanks don't rupture, you have no problems.
What size plane was that?
That was, it looked like a Beechcraft. Baron.
And it's about the size of
twin engine. It'll hold six people. Small family plane. I see the guy got his kids out. I thought he was going for his baggage. He got his kids out the back.
I'd have gone for the baggage.
I got my laptop back here.
All right. Let's do this. Hi, Johnny.
Hey, Russ.
Johnny England from Operation Kindness, No Kill Animal Shelter.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I'm all right.
Good. You in Michigan?
I am.
Good. What's going on at the shelter?
At the shelter, it's been kind of slow with adoptions this week. I think everybody is, you know, kind of bummed out about the war and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean that we still don't have wonderful animals for adoption. And three, real quickly, I wanted to mention, they have one thing in common, and that's that I found them. I rescued them. And they're great dogs. There's Valentine, who is about a 6 or 7 year old Gordon setter. She's a big girl. She weighs about 63 pounds, but she's really pretty. She has a black and brown wavy coat. Really sweet, quiet, calm dog.
Mm-hmm.
We have Bella, who is a beautiful dog. She's 10 months old. She's a Dalmatian pointer mix.
Mm-hmm.
She's housebroken. She's calm. She's great with kids, great with dogs. She's just a wonderful dog. And we have Polly, who is a black and white American Staffordshire Terrier mix, and that's a pit bull, for those who know. But she's really got very fine features. She's about a 40-pound dog,
mm-hmm.
and she's just a great dog.
And that's a dog...
Of course, a whole bunch more.
That's a dog that you need a big backyard and plenty of children.
Mm-hmm. I know why you think so. No, she's good with kids. She's not
yes,
good with kids.
I know. I've seen that.
Okay.
How about any cats? You got any killer cats?
No killer cats.
Yeah.
Sweet cats.
All right. We've got an auction going on for the shelter right now. Do you know about that?
No, I didn't. I've been gone. What do you got?
Phillips Electronics gave us a DVD recorder.
Wow.
So we're just, they gave us two of them. Mm-hmm. One of them for me and one to auction off for the animal shelter. I think it's up to like 5:15 right now.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. When does it close?
3 or 4 days.
I'm sorry?
3 or 4 days.
Oh, cool. So, on hootiehoots.com?
Yes.
Cool. I'll look that up.
Okay. Well, have a lovely trip. When are you back?
I'm back next Tuesday.
Great.
I'm here for my niece's birthday.
Exciting. How old is she?
She is 12 today. Her name is Natalie.
That's too bad.
Too bad?
Do you need to ride home?
She's 12, then her name is Natalie.
You need to ride home from the airport?
No, I've got my car out there.
Good. All right. 45 minutes. What do you guys want to do?
Mm-hmm.
We already did news, right?
We did news. We can do another one.
No, I don't want to do news. Is there anything else breaking?
I was reading this. Well, Eddie, where did the bomb go off just a little bit ago?
In Kuwait City.
Kuwait City.
They were figuring out what that was?
Actually, right now it's still up in the air. They don't know if it was a missile attack or like a car bomb or something.
No, it says it's a missile. It just said this is the first missile attack. No warning sirens proceeded.
Testing the air in some way, maybe with a chemical biological sensor.
This is audio from CNN.
No one at any time has worn any gas masks. That never seemed to be a significant concern from any of the rescue workers that are on the scene. When we drove up, again, quickly, we did not see any ambulances racing off, and we're pretty assured that, in fact, no one had been injured again. It's just before 2 o'clock in the morning when this occurred, Aaron.
Okay, Wolf, has Wolf. There been a...
Wolf!
Had the Kuwaitis, is it your sense that the Kuwaitis guard had been dropped in the sense that there had been these launches since the war?
Do they know where this missile's come from?
There had been no strikes.
Usually just outside of Basra.
Take for granted that they were.
So who fired this?
Yeah, I mean, this wasn't one of our errands, was it?
Oh, no. They're pretty sure the Iraqis have been launching them pretty much almost every day.
Oh, I get it.
But our Patriots have been knocking them down.
Sirens go off here in Kuwait.
They missed one.
They're saying the sirens never even went off.
Was destroyed,
I mean,
by a
there was no. That's what's weird about this is from the early reports, the warning system completely failed.
Gone out and destroyed one of those launchers near Basra that was seen as being responsible for several of the missiles that came in here to Kuwait. So there was a sense that maybe the threat had been removed. Certainly, with every
it looked like it did a whole lot of damage.
Incident, there were a dozen previous missiles launched at Kuwait. About 2.5 million people live in this small country. With every incident that went by,
I don't see anything that's burnt.
Missiles destroyed by a Patriot.
Unless I'm missing part of the picture, but some of the stuff they're showing just looks like it went through a building, through the ceiling, and you see sheetrock and stuff laying around.
Huge numbers here in Kuwait would successfully be able to protect this emirate, which has strongly supported the United States in this war against Iraq.
You're listening to the audio of Wolf
Blitzer. Still over there at the mall, CNN's John Voss. John, give us a little bit more flavor of what's happening right now in the aftermath of this missile going near that shopping mall.
Wolf, what is quite remarkable about this situation is almost how
we said barking him every time.
Certainly a lot of emergency vehicles, but
thanks, Wolf.
It is surreal in a way because it seems very much in hand. It seems as if the emergency services here had in many, many ways been expecting something like this to happen, quite understandably given...
All right, you get a feel for what's going on.
One person injured so far, nobody killed. But it's 1:30 in the morning and landed, they said, in a canal next to the mall. So that may be the reason you don't see anything burned.
Oh. All right. Whatever. Why is DeWine on the phone?
Hold on.
Yes, Rod?
What's up, Russ?
Hi, Rod.
Hey.
Yes,
what's up, man? I got a problem.
All right.
Can you play Emmitt Smith again? you killed me yesterday, man. I'm a bus driver, man. I was popping curves yesterday when he said about the fish hook to do. Then he went pow. Give me that again, bro.
Did you tell O'Malley that you were pissed off?
Yeah. I know he wouldn't have put me through.
No, yeah, he would. We love all our black people.
I love O'Malley too. So, hey man, do that for me one more time, man. I'm out here driving. I'm a 20-hour a week listener. I go from three to seven every day.
You don't listen after 7 o'clock?
I gave him a listen the other night when he was talking about the war because you don't actually get into it that much. But other than that, his voice drains me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, please, you ain't got nothing else to do, so come on.
You don't know I got nothing else to do, but you know,
Smith, man.
Well, I don't know we have the audio from that, but I believe that we may have a report soon from Woodrow in Baghdad.
Oh, is he going to be?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, another thing, too, Russ.
Yes.
I need a 911 call from, you ain't did a 911 call in a long time.
All right, I'll take care of that, too. All right, when this turned into a request line?
I don't know.
I'd like to have a 911 call.
Yeah.
I'd like to have a song.
Okay.
And I'd like to hear Emmett and his big in hands.
Mm.
Can you get that on for me?
Yes. Yeah. Your song yesterday was one of the classics.
Why?
It was just almost in your key, and it was very funny.
What was it about? Oh, I love the black people.
Oh. I made the promo out of it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. Short version, obviously.
Let's see. Hold on a second. Eddie's not in here, so I got to load it. Vertical. Everett, listen to this song and tell me what key it is. Because whatever it is, I'm this close
okay
to hitting it.
Okay.
Last
next time on the Russ Martin Show.
I don't know what I'm going to sing. This is a love song. It's how I appreciate the black community for supporting me.
Oh.
I'm your honky buddy, white like silly buddy, your color I cannot see.
I need to check it out on the guitar.
No. Well, that guitar's not in tune. It's not that important. All right, Duana's on the phone. Hi, sweetie.
Hi, darling.
How are things there at the amazing household?
Oh, wonderful. I never knew you could serenade so well.
I know. It's getting quite amazing.
It is. It's quite amazing. Mm.
What's going on?
Oh, not much. I just called to see about you and to tell you to tell your father happy birthday from me.
Okay. I certainly will if I talk to him anytime soon.
Jeez.
What?
Go out of your way to see him this weekend.
I called him at Christmas.
Right.
If you called him at Christmas?
Yeah.
This is now April almost.
Is it really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I call him at Christmas.
He'll probably call him on April Fool's Day, too.
That's right. I won't be home.
Mm. Uh-huh. See?
Yes, I'll call him. I got plenty of stuff for him.
Well, see, you ought to go see your daddy, and you ought to be calling him.
I will.
Okay.
What are you working on? Did you start doing those things out of your house yet?
Yes, I have. I'm doing seminars, and I'm doing readings again. Some time to do that.
I'm surprised you don't just... How many people can you get in your house?
Quite a few.
You let these people come to your house?
Yeah, and I enjoy them. We had a real good time last night, and I've had a few other nights that I've done it, and I've been enjoying it. It's fun to teach for me.
What are you teaching them?
I'm teaching them how to do what I do. You need to come.
I ain't coming.
You need to come.
I'm psychic enough.
Are you still scared of ghosts?
Mm-hmm.
Why? J.D.'s not scared of ghosts, are you, J.D.?
Mm-hmm. They never hurt you.
It's just not something I want to see, because I know damn well if I ever see one, it's going to be in the middle of the night when I'm going down the stairs.
No, it will not.
Oh, the hell it won't.
It won't. You want me to... Now, see, that's one of the things...
I don't want to talk about this anymore because you ruined my house.
Wait, woman. Just shut up and listen.
You
just don't know.
I learned something.
I'm always learning. But let me tell you something. I ask ghosts to come in while I'm teaching, and they do, and people see them while I'm teaching. So let me do it for you.
I don't want any spooks or big spook hands.
They're not. They don't have big spook hands. And some of those women that are spooks...
They might kill me with their big spook hands.
Nah. They would not.
You don't know that.
I do know that. I talk to them all the time.
I can't with my big spoon. Mm-hmm.
No, yes. They would not. They would not. They're nice people.
Hey, Duana, have you ever heard of the Jefferson Hotel? We go out there and it scares the hell out of Joy.
I have heard of it, but I've never been there, I don't think.
Okay.
I don't think.
All right, okay.
Why, are y'all going out there?
No. Been out there before.
Where's it at?
Jefferson, Texas.
You know, I'd love to go there.
Yeah, well, it's... I'd love to sit here and visit for another half hour, but my psychic sense says this bit sucks.
Are you being ugly about me?
Just a little. How do people get into your seminar?
Oh, well, they can go to my website, and when there's a place on the right-hand side that says an evening with Duana.
Which one is this? Is this Daily Horoscopes, Duana.com, or what?
Either one of them, because you can get to all of them from the side.
All right, it's on the front page of my website, just go to RussMartin.com.
Sure can.
Okay.
Okay.
What does this cost?
For an evening with Duana, about $100.
How many hours is that?
2.5 hours.
And do you do readings while you're in the middle of this?
Yeah, and so did they.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Uh-huh. So did they. We have a good time and see ghosts and see each other's ghosts.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're a ghost, too. You know that.
Yes, I know. In a meaty body.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
I got it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's the spirit.
Well, I got to go.
Well, okay.
Love you too much.
You.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
Bye, Duana.
Amazing Duana bird. You shaking the log? Again?
Busy today.
Oh. Is that an angry black man on 7?
Good.
Earl, welcome to the show.
Yeah, what's happening, man?
Certainly happy to have you.
Yeah, I was just listening to your song, man. I don't understand what's the meaning behind it.
I don't know. Which part did you not understand?
You know, you're talking about you got love for the Negroes and all that. Don't you think it's enough going on already?
What, I can't? You can't have another white man love you?
Yeah.
I love you.
I can understand that, but then, you know, your song, man, didn't sound like too much love. Sound like you trying to be funny.
No, I love you.
You love me?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, didn't sound like it, though, man.
Why are you not feeling the love?
It sounded like you was being funny, man.
Mm-mm.
How much love did you spread?
Tons.
Besides the song.
I can't. If I wish I could weigh it.
You wish you could play it.
Weigh it.
I'm saying, what else? What
you're
else?
Not, you're not angry enough. Call me back later when you're really pissed. Yeah. Knock back another 40, and then give me a call in about 20 minutes. Let me know if he calls right back.
We'll be back with the Russ Martin Show.
All right, 6:33. J.D. Ryan is here. Trey Trent, home. Everett Newton. Eddie Boyd, Dan O'Malley. Got life puts off today. Was that the professor, Russell Johnson, on the hotline?
Yes.
How you doing?
You've been talking about people that you're interested in their opinion on the war.
Oh, yeah, I mentioned that last week. Professor?
Yeah, hey, Russell, how are you?
I'm quite lovely, and how are you?
I'm just lovely, too.
And how's the Connie?
She's even lovelier.
I am lovelier.
Oh, oh no.
She's right there.
It is so nauseating to hear them together.
So much in love.
How long have you guys been married?
Huh?
How long have you been married?
Connie? How long have we been married?
Over 20 years, but we've known each other since 1955. We go back a long way, Russ.
There you go.
And it's just any time that you call over the house, mm-hmm. they're always chit-chatting. It's always love talk back and forth. It's
lovely.
If you ever accidentally swallow poison,
right.
Call her house.
Yeah.
God.
It's sickening, isn't it?
It's very endearing.
It's cute, but it's nauseating because there's no way that you could be with somebody that long and be in love. I think it's an act.
It is. It's an act that we really cherish.
Yeah, but we've worked on it. You know, we've got it down.
See?
Yeah, we've worked very hard on a good relationship.
They probably hang up the phone. She starts swinging him around by his feet.
Oh, hey, you better. No, we're both very volatile. Please believe me.
Do you guys have knockdowns?
Oh, we do.
Oh.
Yeah, we get into it.
Oh, I'd love to hear that.
What keeps you alive?
So you guys obviously have been watching all the war coverage.
Yeah,
we've been watching.
And I brought this up last week. Everybody in Hollywood's running their mouth, and I don't give a rat's ass about anybody, except if you were an actor and you actually served our country, then I'd be interested to hear what you had to say.
Uh-huh.
We had Ed McMahon on earlier this week. He was a general colonel. He was a colonel in the
Marine Corps, yeah.
Yeah. And
what did he say?
He said they should shut up, too.
Yeah.
Who should shut up? Oh, actors, you mean that have liberal opinions or any opinion?
And where do the Johnsons stand on this?
On what?
On the whole war thing.
Well, I tell you what, I'm a veteran, and I pray and I'm concerned for all those guys and girls, men and women over there, and for their safety. This is, I think, going to be a lot tougher than people were told or people expected.
Well, that's what some of the news reports today said, that not that they really underestimated the troops over there. It was just a bigger undertaking than they planned. I'm sure that they didn't plan on, 100-mile-an-hour sandstorms.
Well, not only that. The point is that you're in somebody else's country, and they're going to defend it, Believe me, everybody thought, oh, hell, these guys are going to lay down their arms. They're not going to do that.
I thought at first, after that first day of bombing Baghdad, the first real day, I thought, you know what? They're going to see this, and everybody's going to lay down their weapons, and this thing's going to be over with.
A lot of them did.
Well, that's,
It was naive. If you want to win a war, you better know your enemy and know him well. And I tell you, we were in such unfamiliar territory where it's heartrending.
Do you guys think that we went over there too soon?
Isn't that we went over, I really want to censor what I say because
I say whatever you want.
My voice. I love the boys and girls, and I'm thinking, boy, those guys with the purple hair and the tattoos mm-hmm. and earrings in every extremity, they are willing to go out and risk their lives, and now their parents are full of love and pride for these children, as well they should be.
Russell, you didn't
really come through for us.
Russell, you didn't get drafted. You actually enlisted, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. Yeah. Sure, on my 18th birthday, man. I couldn't wait.
See, that's
I'm gonna go over there and just lay those people out.
I think that's a whole mentality that's changed, because I was 18. Mm-hmm. First thing I was going to do is get my ass into college on the outside chance that we invaded, what was it, Afghanistan?
Yeah.
In 1980.
Yeah.
I couldn't stay in college long enough. And then I don't even think you got a whole college deferment. I think you got maybe 6 months.
Well, you know, it was a different world at the time of the Second World War. That was another matter, another era, another time. And this country was 100% behind the men. Everything worked 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Women got out of the house and went to work. And, I mean, this was an astonishing kind of thing that happened.
Yeah.
You know, it was there's no comparison to any other war.
Our country owes these darling men, wonderful men and women, big time.
Doesn't she sound like Rocky the Squirrel?
Huh?
You sound like Rocky the Squirrel.
Well, I've got to listen to Rocky the Squirrel again on, what was that cartoon? It was
Rocky and Bullwinkle.
Yeah.
Rocky and Bullwinkle.
Well, there you are. Anyway, Connie.
Time for your ass open.
Take a breath.
He goes, look at here, 4:38, time to swing you around. Are you, Russell, are you going to do any other appearances? You working on anything?
Well, right now it's kind of quiet. There's, a few things in the wind, but I can't really talk about it because it hasn't been set. So I'm just saying I'm in a holding and waiting period right now for some good news. When it happens, I'll let you know.
Yeah, I wish you would.
I certainly will.
You guys have been very kind to us.
Well, we love you, Russell. You're a good man.
Does this strike anybody else as weird?
It always does.
Yes. Well, I mean, every time that we talk to you guys, not you, Connie, because I don't want you on TV, but every time that, although you sound like Rocky the Squirrel, but every time we talk to the Johnsons, it's just weird knowing that that's the same person from Gilligan's Island.
I know.
Yeah, well, I'm a little older, you know.
But you are still a piece of ass.
I'm 38 now.
He is.
Call him a piece of ass, Connie. Say it.
Oh, Russell.
Say it.
I'm coming down here, man. I'm gonna let you have it, boy.
I'll get you out of that Hawaiian shirt and work you up.
I'm taking my belt off right now.
Good. Pants come off quicker.
I'm getting after you.
Sounds like Connie's clue.
Yeah. All right. Well, we won't keep you guys. It was very kind of you to call.
Anyway, we love you, Russell. Good luck to you.
Thank you, sir.
And we'll talk with you soon, I hope.
I'll call you guys over the weekend.
Okay, good. Okay.
All right. Love you both.
Nice talking to you. Love
bye-bye.
You.
Bye-bye.
That's Russell Johnson. Website is russelljohnson.tv. What?
Nothing. You call him over the weekend. Drunk.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah.
Every time I call, it's like I start thinking, I should call him. I should call and thank him for serving our country.
Exactly.
Thank you, sir, for serving our country.
I'll salute you now.
I salute you. And he knows now.
Well,
you're drunk, aren't you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But I love you.
And then you wake up the next morning and go, please tell me, God, please, that was a dream.
Oh, my favorite thing is to get up the next morning and check my scent file on email.
Oh,
see who I chewed out.
Yeah.
You always know when you get an email at 3:27 in the morning.
I always check the time.
Not always drunk.
No.
The odds are in your favor.
Yes.
Very much so.
Yes.
I like him.
I like him a lot. Great guy. It was surreal when we flew out to, well, you guys went to LA, I didn't, but in Midland when we were sitting there having lunch with him, I'm just like,
so bizarre.
And you know what? Here's the other thing, and then we'll move on. Was he knew that we were a bunch of kids, and he was a professor.
Absolutely.
And he could have, you know, said, look, get over it. It was 35 years ago. I'm an old man. I dribble in my drawers. Shut up. Buy me lunch and get out.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't. He sat there and told stories and talked about his kid as one of his sons died like 7-8 years ago. Mm-hmm. I got drunk, called him on Father's Day.
Mm, God.
Russell!
Oh, no.
This is me!
Sky on Father's Day.
Honey, change the number.
So, there you go. That's very nice.
Can we do this first? We got a break.
Can we take a short one?
We never take short breaks. What's the matter with you?
It'll be shorter than the other ones.
I can't wait. All right. You got it loaded? All right, quick break, and we'll come back. We have something to give away.
Uh-huh.
All right, good. What are we playing?
Kind of entertainment Jeopardy.
Huh.
Mostly TV and just some other stuff thrown in.
Questions and audio?
Questions and audio.
All right, perfect. I'm excited. Can't wait. Wish it was then.
Mm-hmm.
I had to play this.
Oh, yeah.
And I have played this.
And I work at KVIO.
I'd kill myself if I had to work at KVIO.
I enjoyed it. It was a...
I'm talking about the music.
Oh, now.
Yeah. Do they call it light rock?
Yeah, light rock for the something or other. I don't know what they call it. Back then, it was a cool station. When I worked there, it was... Yep.
What is it now?
It's just light rock.
Too bad.
Yes.
All right.
What are we doing here?
Oh, we're going to play this thing. Ready to go, Eddie?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, nice.
Welcome to Idiot Savant Jeopardy. And now, here's the host of Idiot Savant Jeopardy, Russ Martin.
What are we playing for, John?
We'll be playing for 12 months bronze level web hosting from vergebiz.com, the official website host for Live 105.3 and the Russ Martin Show. Plus, more new fine arts gift certificate, 4 pack of passes to the lodge, Dr. Pepper racing t-shirt, and finally a 6-disc collection edition of NYPD Blue from 20th Century Home Fox.
I believe that's the first year, isn't it?
Right.
That's when that redheaded guy was still there.
Mm-hmm.
Then he went off for his fabulous movie career. A letdown for him. He goes out, he has 2 or 3 crap movies, and he's back on television. Idiot. All right. Where's that come up, Eddie? Right here? Did you call that guy that Dover suggested?
Yeah, I did.
What'd he say?
You want to do this now?
Yeah, it won't take but a minute.
He said he was interested.
Is he going to fly in?
Yes.
Okay.
He's never done entertainment-type talk radio. He's only done serious talk radio.
But he can produce.
Yes. He's yeah. He's done a lot of producing in Dallas, and he's in Kansas City now, KCMO, I believe.
All right.
Young guy. Dover, highly recommended. He worked with Dover. He's our organization.
Good.
I explained the whole ahead-of-the-show thing.
Did he just seem to understand it?
Yeah.
Good.
He gave a couple of quotes. He was like, you got 3 topics going. I should be ahead of all 3 of them.
Oh, yes. Oh, he got that?
Yeah.
Wow. What?
3 topics?
Yeah.
Yeah. If we only had 3 topics going at one time, that would be fine.
You can't stay ahead of 1. We're not going to hire him. We're just going to talk to him.
Fine.
I think we should see other people.
It's been 5 months.
And it's a great 5 months.
Things have been getting much better.
Not for me.
Yeah.
Well, how do you know? I want to get up at noon and not have to worry about the show. That's what I want. That's never going to happen.
Until we get a producer.
You get things hours in advance. I mean, 12.
Ah, you got James Brown today. Whoop-de-doo. 3-minute interview.
Ed McMahon.
I'm glad to be in Dallas. I got to go. The proof is in my hand.
This guy says he would just bring a variety of topics to Dover and let him pick and choose whichever way he went. He did whatever he didn't use. The guy goes, I don't get my feelings hurt. If they don't use them, then they just start you trashing. That's the way it works.
Dover does topical radio.
Oh, all of a sudden, you know how to produce?
It would be it'd be a lot easier than this.
Fine. So does this guy, can he do it? Is there any?
Can he? Absolutely.
Yeah. Any red flags?
Well, yeah. I don't know how much of this you want on the air.
I care?
He has a couple issues. He's like,
if I wanted to hide it, we wouldn't be talking about it.
He says,
and Trey just thinks it's a bit, so we can talk about it for an hour.
He goes, yes, I know how to direct and direct the talent. And
what?
That's what I said. I went, well, Russ really kind of goes his own way. He goes, I know how to hone them back in and direct them.
Oh, he does?
Yeah. I went, well, okay.
And what's the other flag?
The other thing is he says, plus I do the same level of concentration on my own show on the weekends, and I'd like to do that.
Oh, there. No. No.
I'd sort of like to do that down there, too.
To help him out, if you'd like, I can send him one of the monthly archives of emails I have between Russ and I. He can go through the, it's usually about 800 a month. So,
damn.
I do a lot of stuff.
I know you do.
Nobody has any idea what it takes to put this schlock together on a daily basis. I know it sounds like it's thrown together. It's supposed to. It's that way by design.
Right.
So that way on the days that we really just do throw it together, it sounds like all the other ones.
Makes sense.
Thank you.
So, yeah.
Nobody has any idea what work I put into this show. Nobody.
I do somewhat.
No, you don't.
Yeah, I do. I don't. I'm not saying I do the same level of work because I don't. But I see how hard you work. I've been there, not in this kind of a show, certainly. But
so he knows how to keep me on track.
That's kind of what he said because I said, "Yeah, you got to be out. Think of yourself. You're the blocker. You're out in front." He goes, "Yeah, I know how to rein him in and keep him behind me."
This I gotta see.
Yeah. Just can I watch?
Well, he was trying his best. He's never heard the show. He's got family here.
Did he produce for Dover?
He produced for Dover. He also produces for a daily afternoon show in Kansas City.
Oh. I'm not sure this guy's going to work out.
Damn, that didn't take long.
But it would be fun to watch.
Yeah, it would. Because you know how real producers, they'll slam against you, Trey. It's just happen.
just a bonus.
Yeah. It's like getting gravy from Greece. Yeah. The real producer were to come in, because they come in and go, all right, at 5 p.m. we have James Brown. At 5:17, we're going to have this. So you'll need to do this and start wrapping up right here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, whatever. Exactly. That's the problem.
And then at 5:15, James Brown's been on hold for 15 minutes.
Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm.
Do you hear me calling ex-girlfriend? Get out of here.
Yeah, he didn't quite grasp that. That's why I'd send him a copy of the show to kind of give him an idea of where you go from time to time.
You can't. You cannot understand this show by listening to it.
I don't get it, and I'm standing here.
But the work that goes into the show.
It's amazing. Uh-huh. It's overwhelming.
Mm.
It's a tidal wave.
It's
avalanche flavor.
It is.
Yeah, send him in here and try and keep the show on track.
Okay. Well,
I want to watch.
A lot of times, that's what a producer does. Actually does try to keep the talent on track.
Two words.
Huh?
Tough nookies. Get out of the studio and take your palm tree pass with you.
Go on.
Yeah. That's right. All right. We have time to do this, Eddie?
Absolutely not.
Are you serious?
Damn.
We got enough spots to take us to 7-4.
Oh, let's just play one clip.
See, a producer would have kept you on track. We would have got the game going.
You no longer have time to do your game because you've gone too long. Tough noogies.
We can go over.
Now, get out of here and take your dead baby hall pass.
Yeah, you'd make a real producer cry hard.
Play one clip, and then we'll break.
Where is it? Right here? Yeah.
All right.
Okay, these are actually going to be historical things from television.
Go ahead. Try it again. Go.
I am acutely aware that you have not elected me as your president by your ballots.
Right. What is
so I ask you
Gerald
to
Ford's acceptance speech?
Absolutely.
As your
very nice. Do another one.
With your
It appears as though something has happened in the motorcade route. Something, Jeez. I repeat, has happened
that
in the motorcade
route. That is the audio from the assassination of John F. Kennedy.
Alongside Elm Street, there by the Simmons Freeway.
That's kind of cool. Mm-hmm. Do another one.
Happy birthday.
Sorry. Marilyn Monroe singing happy birthday to JFK.
Correct.
This will be the day when all of God...
J.D.
What is the I Have a Dream speech from Martin Luther King?
Absolutely.
How ironic. Go ahead, play another one.
My fellow Americans, I'm pleased to tell you today that I've signed legislation.
This is Reagan's joke from his Saturday radio address.
Yes.
I didn't know the mic was on.
Yeah.
We'll all Russia forever. We begin bombing in 5 minutes.
That's one small step for man.
Russ. This is the landing of Apollo. Apollo 7 on the moon.
Actually, I don't know what Apollo it was.
I get credit for it.
You don't get credit. It was the first moon landing.
Yeah. What?
It was Neil Armstrong stepping onto the moon.
It was the first Apollo. It was the first landing moon. Moon landing. That's where it was. Landing on the moon. I got it.
All right. That was actually all I had because it was supposed to mix in with.
Oh. All right.
It'll be audio clues.
Okay, then we'll take a break here. It'll be a nice long 15-minute break. Roll 'em.
We'll be back with the Russ Martin Show.
All right. All right. We're done.
Okay.
You got the plugs ready?
I do.
All right.
Thanks to the Big Apple Cafe, 360 Trinity in Arlington, 817-57 Apple for our food today. Also for the lighting and sound equipment for the movie, it's American Media Solutions, 972-323-5212, AmericanMediaSolutions.com. Also, MLD Equipment Rental, that's 214-654-9977.
Am I guessing this is where we got all our free stuff for the movie here tonight?
All the stuff in the hall is from these folks.
Okay, cool.
Okay. For more information about the Russ Martin Show, you can email us, or for details on the Listeners Foundation and Police and Firefighter posters, simply go to RussMartin.com to instant email us during the show, only during the show, studio@RussMartin.com. To see Trey and visit his website, go to TreyTrenholm.com and soon PinkNipples.com. To find Eddie on the World Wide Web, go to EddieBoyd.com. Me and my picture gallery, go to JohnDavidRyan.com. For law issues, contact Ever Newton at DallasAttorney.com or call him at 214-823-LAWS. Limousine service provided by Ultimate Limousines. Call George at 214-668-5363. To make a donation or adopt a pet, go to OperationKindness.org. Call them 972-418-PAWS. And the official site for the Talk That Rocks is live1053.com.
All right. See you guys Monday.
See you.
Bye.